broadcast of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by WatchMyBit.com, the first ever micropayment-based video service. If you're a content creator, visit WatchMyBit.com to learn how you can use Bitcoin to generate revenue for your art. That's WatchMyBit.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 16th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. An investigation by the Washington Times has found that nonprofit organizations funded by billionaire George Soros helped fund protests in Ferguson and contributed to social media campaigns. The Times reports the Open Society Foundations gave at least $33 million in grants to a number of groups involved in grassroots activism following the shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Some groups monitored and exploited news events that they could portray as a conservative misstep. The groups use shared content and buzzwords to create a social media echo chamber of Facebook likes and Twitter hashtags that would garner media attention. Kenneth Zimmerman, the director of the Open Society Foundation's U.S. programs, said the groups were funded by Soros through the foundation, but stressed the nonprofit did not have the ability to control or dictate what others say or choose to say. The former mayor of Iguala, Mexico, has been charged in the kidnapping of 43 students who have been missing since September of 2014. Former Mayor Jose Luis Abarca Thomas Zeron, Director of Criminal Investigations at the Federal Attorney General's Office, stated that a warrant had been issued for Abarca's arrest and 44 other officials. The students' disappearance has been connected to local police working with a drug gang in collaboration with the mayor and his wife. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat. For Friday, January 16th, 2015, I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Thank you, Jode. I appreciate you taking up this issue.
Berto, if a man ain't cooked crisp on the hellfire desert, ain't he ought to be left on his own?
Well, right, Jode. Immigrants are desperate for a better way of life.
We need the strongest of these crude backward browns to keep us all alive. I see the ones that can swim the Rio Grande, too. Berto, you swum that border river to get here, ain't you?
Jode, not all Mexicans came here by swimming the Rio Grande.
No. I got sympathy. I crossed Huron Lake in a barrel myself using hands as paddles, lived off the carp. What jumped at me? Now, you swum that river, ain't you?
No, Jode, actually, I was born here.
What you know about hard work? Ain't never swum no river.
Many immigrants, they
deserve to be... I say you ain't never knowed a man till you seen his teeth. Show him your teeth. Too many teeth rotting out shows you're dishonest in the mind. You got strong man full teeth, Barto. I apologize.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free and take control of these airwaves. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And you can join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So feel free to reach out to us that way if you prefer. In fact, I prefer because generally you will sound better if you're on Skype. So take the effort if you don't already have it to, if you like the idea of calling in to participate, add Skype to your computer or your smartphone because it's worth it. I know it's made by Microsoft, and sure, it's going to probably allow the NSA to spy on everything you say, but you're calling a radio show, so anyone can listen to what you say anyway. So it doesn't matter. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. I've been teasing the story about Venezuela for like a week. I feel like we should probably get to it. But coming up, the latest on the Silk Road / Ross Ulbricht trial that we have been covering all week long here in, I would say, fairly good detail.
And we'll probably continue doing for the next 4 to 6 weeks.
I certainly intend to. Yeah, I think it's probably one of the most important cases of our time. Certainly the most important case that I know of happening right now. And there's a lot to talk about. Now, today, there was no actual courtroom action. There was nothing that happened today because, I don't know, for whatever reason, they took the day
off.
No
giant revelation or...
Nothing. Just nothing happened in the courtroom. And nothing. So, for whatever reason, yesterday was the last day for this week. They're going to, as I understand it, resume trial on Monday.
If I had to guess, I would say that because it took 2 days for the first witness...
Mm-hmm.
And if you figure on average 2 days per witness,
yep.
You don't want to start a witness on Friday
and then
have to pick up with him on Monday and then, you know, totally forget where you were.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So I don't know what the reason for it was, but regardless, there are still some folks up there in New York City. I understand that John Bush is going to try to come back next week. He's looking to raise money to do that. You might be able to help him out over at thelibertybeat.com. He's just done an amazing job so far this week, keeping track of everything that's been going on in and outside of the courtroom over at thelibertybeat.com. So we've got an update on the man who has now been accused of being Dread Pirate Roberts, the same guy who owned MT Gox. Now, longtime listeners of the show will recognize the name MT Gox, probably won't recognize the name Mark Karpeles. Honestly, I didn't know the guy's name until just a few days ago. I'd seen it before, but it didn't really ring a bell with me or anything like that.
Yeah, when I saw the name last night, I was thinking, like, I know this name, but I don't know why I know this name.
Yeah, so he's responded to the accusation that he is the actual Dread Pirate Roberts, and we can read his response. Plus, Vice.com is reporting that the jury in the Silk Road trial doesn't get the internet, and they say that's a problem. So that's all stuff we can talk about. Plus, Daryl, you've got an interesting story about asset forfeiture, which is a horrible thing. However, it appears that there may be some restrictions being placed upon
yes.
it, which is good news. But first, this is, now to be fair, it's a little bit old. I bookmarked this one about a week ago, but the situation in Venezuela is certainly not getting better anytime soon. We've been following Venezuela off and on Free Talk Live over the last few years. It's just a fascinating study in failure of socialism. And of course, the people who are running Venezuela would point to other factors as to why their country is not able to have toilet paper and other basic items. They like to blame the United States for their problems, but really it's a problem with socialism and controlling the marketplace with government.
Right, but when you have sanctioned and embargoes on a country, that doesn't exactly help.
Are there sanctions on Venezuela from the United States?
I believe that there are some. It's not, you know, anywhere near as severe as the sanctions against Cuba.
Okay.
But I am 99.9% positive that there are some kind of sanctions against Venezuela.
Well, you know, even if you can't trade with the United States, and again, I don't know to what extent those sanctions exist, but even if let's just say you couldn't trade with the United States, that still leaves the other 200 countries in the world or however many that you could do business with. And the fact that the government is essentially standing in the way of business in Venezuela is a major reason why stuff doesn't work. And plus, you got not only does the government stand in the way in Venezuela, they've nationalized some businesses in Venezuela, including grocers.
Yes.
It's just an insane situation. The story is coming from Bloomberg.com, where shoppers thronged grocery stores across Caracas today. This was written last Friday, as deepening shortages led the government to put Venezuela's food distribution under military protection. Long lines, some stretching for blocks, formed outside of grocery stores in the South American country's capital as residents search for scarce basic items such as detergent and chicken.
So they're getting rations then? Like they're getting a set amount of rations per day?
I don't even know if it's rations at this point. I mean, the store shelves in a lot of cases are just empty. So they're just trying to find anything they can find. And just try to imagine for a moment. I mean, we take our lifestyle here in the United States as for granted. I mean, it very rarely happens that you go into a grocery store and they're sold out of something.
Unless
you
happen to go to Market Basket this summer, past summer.
Right. That was, you're referencing the grocery store chain that had some internal strife and mm-hmm. there was strikes and things like that. But on average, you know, when you go into
sure,
a grocer,
yeah.
there's never a shortage of anything because, well, the market, when left to its own devices, when business owners are able to trade and buy and sell and do business with generally without the federal government or state governments meddling in every transaction, then they're able to bring products to the consumer at a relatively cheap price and manage to make a profit at the same time and keep all the lights turned on and all these employees employed and everybody is happy here in the United States. But try to imagine for a moment that you could not find chicken, that you could not find detergent. And they don't mention it here, but toilet paper was the one that we talked about most recently in Venezuela as being one of the shortages. This was several months ago.
Wow.
That it was tough to get toilet paper in Venezuela because of these government insane controls on their currency, which we'll touch on that here in a moment. So these lines are stretching outside of grocery stores. Imagine that too. Imagine having to wait outside of the store just to get in the store in the hopes that eventually you might be able to find some scraps that
you could purchase. I was at the grocery store just before coming on the air tonight, and I was getting frustrated that there were seven lines that weren't moving. there's like 20 lines total, but only seven of them are open and none of them are moving, including the self-checkout. And then ultimately I found one of the self-checkouts that nobody was at, but people were just standing behind. So I just went and ran and used it.
Do you like the self-checkouts?
They're faster.
Yeah. Are they? I don't know.
Especially if when you've got like eight people in every line and they're just standing
That's true. I agree with you there. If there is a line, then a self-checkout that has no line is faster. But going one to another, like if you have no line at a person checkout and then you have no line at the self-checkout and you have more than a couple items, you're going to be slower at the self-checkout.
Absolutely.
Right. But I generally only have a couple of items anyway. Okay.
Yeah, if you're buying a lot in bulk or you're getting produce and you have to manually type in the name of the product or fruit
that's
or whatever
slow,
they're purchasing,
because you don't know the numbers.
Exactly,
but the cashier does,
and they're just like click click click. Okay,
bananas are 40-11. That's the only fruit that I remember.
Now I don't know if every self checkout's like this, but the one that I go to Price Chopper, which is a regional grocery chain that's 24 hours in the Northeast, and their self checkouts are notoriously slow.
When
you scan an item, it scans it in right away, but then it takes a moment. Even once you put it in the bag in the weighing area, it still takes it a moment to kind of reset.
Please place in the baggage area.
Yeah, but even after you place it, it takes a decent amount of time to reset, and that time seems to extend the more items you have. So the larger your order is, the slower it gets as you go through it. That said, I still go through it anyway just because I like it.
Well, they always seem to close down those self checkouts late at after 10 o'clock, and then it's usually only I realize there's not really a lot of people at the store after 10 o'clock. But
they always have to have somebody monitoring the self checkouts because somebody's going to walk through with alcohol, and of course they're scared to death that they're going to get busted by the cops, and so they always have to check IDs and that kind of thing. So we'll talk more about Venezuela. I realize we got sidetracked into self checkouts there. You're welcome.
But to answer the question, if there's no line at the self-checkout, no line at a person, I'll go to the person.
Generally, I will too, unless I'm feeling antisocial. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can take control here, and we'll talk more about what's going on in Venezuela, plus the latest on the Russ Ulbricht trial all on the way.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live, the show where anyone can call about whatever they want. And we do mean anyone.
I forgot your name, but we had 9/11, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, if they weren't here, could it have happened?
Could what have happened? If who wasn't here?
How wasted are you?
That's what I want to
know. No, sir. No, I'm not wasted.
Okay.
No, please just listen to me.
Okay.
If the people weren't here that drove the planes into the Twin Towers,
yeah, right? They flew them. They didn't drive them, but okay.
No, I'm not saying that. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Because now
Wow.
Yeah, I got to think a minute.
That's all right.
We got nothing but time.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.FM? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.FM. That's LRN.FM.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free here, and you can bring up anything you want. The latest on the Silk Road and the newest allegations that came out yesterday, the bombshell, for lack of a better term, that it was actually, according to the defense,
Mark Edge.
No, but Mark Karpeles, who is, it would be hilarious if it was Mark Edge, because he can't even operate a computer.
I had heard that he made the announcement a couple nights ago on Free Talk Live.
That he was Dread Pirate
that
Roberts.
That he was Dread Pirate Roberts.
I think everyone was saying they were Dread Pirate Roberts.
No, I'm Dread Pirate Roberts.
Right, one of those, I am what, Spartacus?
I am Spartacus.
Yeah, I'm Dread Pirate Roberts. So, yeah, we'll talk more about what's going on with the Silk Road case. Some pretty outrageous stuff happened yesterday, and now there's a response from Mark Karpeles about the allegations that he is, in point of fact, according to the defense and according to the Department of Homeland Security, a person they were interviewing on the stand was under suspicion for being Dread Pirate Roberts. But also talking about Venezuela and what's happening with the grocery stores there, where apparently now they are under military protection. And I'm not sure why they're under military protection, considering they're sold out of pretty much all the basics. You can't even get chicken, toilet paper, detergent, you know, really basic items you can't get at these stores. But yet there are lines of people.
Well, if you had a grocery store and you had no product on the shelf and people were there for product,
mm-hmm.
they would probably get
a little
upset. They might riot.
That's a good point.
Saying so.
Yeah, that's a good point. All right, so we'll talk more about what's going on there, but first we go to Pete in California. Pete, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Oh, you think that that's bad, the military controlling a supermarket in Venezuela? You wait till that happens in the United States when the economy crashes, you know?
When is that going to happen, Pete? Because I've been hearing for the last 20 years that the economy is about to collapse at any moment.
You know that song by Rage Against the Machine that goes...
No, I can't say I recalled that.
You know what we should do is we should put Rage Against the Machine on a loudspeaker and just take the baseball bat and smash the window and steal all the TVs and...
That's a terrible idea. Why would you suggest something like that?
I was being sarcastic, but yeah, people are going to do that. I forget the sociologist that had that study. I think it's 3 days till anarchy or something like that. If the water, the power, the TV, the basic stuff, you know, quote unquote, like food and whatnot, below that, that's cut off. Within 3 days, he said people are going to go wild. In ancient Israel, when people played the whore and turned their back on Yahweh. The problem is they eventually started eating each other because they had famine, they had disease, pestilence. And we have the audacity nowadays to think that somehow that God's standards and the Ten Commandments are still not the standards and that we can do whatever we want without consequence. I want you to comment on that.
I'm curious what that has to do with the point of the call that was the imminent collapse of the U.S. economy. I'm still curious when the economy is going to collapse because, as I said, I've been hearing for 20 years that the economy is about to collapse.
It's right around the corner, Daryl.
It's right around the corner. So is it right around the corner? Like, you know, next week economy collapses? When does that happen, Pete?
Lindsey Williams from Prophecy Club says that his elite sources from the pipeline when he was a chaplain for them said that during the dollar's going to be in... The dollar is going to be in circulation, but it's not going to be worth jack to buy you food at the store coming up in this fall.
Dollar's actually pretty strong right now. I mean, all things considered, you've got the price of silver's down, the price of Bitcoin's down, the price of gas is down. Thanks, Pete, for your call tonight. I mean, a lot of people are surprised by this.
But he did say this fall. So he did give us a timeline.
It reminded me of this prophet. I guess he was a pastor. I cannot remember the name for the life of me. But
Alex Jones?
No, not Alex Jones.
Is he a pastor?
No, but he makes a lot of prophecies of.
It's true.
Any day now, it's going to happen.
Well, I remember he
predicted. New world order.
He predicted that the end of the world was going to be like May 2nd, 2011, and then it didn't happen. And they said, no, it's going to be this October. Of course, it didn't happen.
Are you thinking about Harold Camping from the church group that has a bunch of
people? Yeah. It's Harold. That sounds familiar.
Yeah, he's dead now.
Yeah, I know he is. Right. That's ironic.
Yeah. Family, I forget what the company's called, like Family Radio or something like that. They own a bunch of radio stations and put just, you know, religious programming on constantly. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. One lady, Elizabeth Elsa, 27-year-old janitor, says, I visited 6 stores already today looking for detergent, and I can't find it anywhere. She's waiting in a line outside of a supermarket in eastern Caracas. She says, quote, we're wearing our dirty clothes again because we can't find it. At this point, I'll buy whatever I can find, unquote. A dearth of foreign currency exacerbated by collapsing oil prices has led to shortages of imports from toilet paper to car batteries and helped push annual inflation to 64% in November. The lines will persist as long as price controls remain in place. Luis Vicente León, director of Caracas-based polling firm Data Analysis, said today in a telephone interview. Government officials met with representatives from supermarket chains today to guarantee supplies, state news agency AVN reported. Interior Minister Carmen Melendez said yesterday security forces would be sent to food stores and distribution centers to protect the shoppers. Don't fall into desperation. We have the capacity and products for everyone with calmness and patience. The stores are full, she said on state television. Now, right next to this quote about the stores being full is a photograph showing empty shelves at a supermarket in the La Boyera part of eastern Caracas.
You just have to imagine that the food is there.
Yeah. The top shelf, there's some stuff up there. Maybe that's because people can't reach. But otherwise, the shelves here have been pretty devastated. President Nicolas Maduro said last week he vowed to implement an economic counteroffensive to steer the country out of recession, including an overhaul of the foreign exchange system. He has yet to provide details. While the main government-controlled exchange rate sets a rate of 6.3 bolivars per U.S. dollar, the black market rate is as much as 187 bolivars per U.S. dollar. Now, it's important to stop here to really explain, and I have to say, I'm not an economist, so I'll do my best at this, to explain why this is insane. So what's going on is the Venezuelan government has essentially put a price control on their own currency, the bolivar.
Yes.
They have determined, arbitrarily, of course, that their bolivar is, you know, what you should get 6.3 bolivars per U.S. dollar. Now, if you actually have a U.S. dollar and you go into the streets of Venezuela and you know who to talk to, you can get as much as 187 bolivars for that dollar. So there's a huge...
I'll take the 187, please, yeah. Alex.
Now, that's the top. You know, that's the top tier. That's, you got to know the right people. You got to be dealing with a lot of dollars, that kind of thing, or whatever. But there's also, you know, any range between usually like 60... Because last time we were talking about this, it was usually going for like 60 to 70 bolivars per dollar. So 10 times the official rate. Now it's 187 in some instances. So what this does is it completely just messes with the economy. And we can talk more about how that happens here in a little bit. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Because if you're trying to do business sort of on Front Street, you have to use the official exchange rate. But if you do business in the black market, you can use the black market exchange rate and get a much better deal if you can get your hands on dollars in Venezuela. There's more coming up. Free Talk Live.
Genesis is defined as an origin, creation, or the beginning. Genesis Communications Network began with the mission of providing you with the kind of compelling content you're listening to now. And at GCNlive.com, you'll find a free archive of our nation's history, narrated by GCN hosts. Explore, share, and pass down to future generations. GCN is the future of talk radio, but we should always strive to learn from our past. Together, we are GCNlive.com. GCN.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Thanks to Bitcoin, LRN.FM is able to provide our free-to-air satellite channel across North and Central America. You can listen to LRN.FM 24/7 via satellite for no monthly cost. Learn more about our satellite channel at sat.lrn.fm. And if you'd like to help us continue to expand, you can send us Bitcoins via the address you'll find under the Bitcoin graphic in the right column of LRN.FM. To learn more about Bitcoin, visit weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Do you need access to money? Do you need cash today? If you are receiving a structured settlement due to a lawsuit, or you are receiving pension payments over a long period of time, The Money Settlement Hotline can get you instant funding now. With your cash today, you can pay off credit card debt, pay medical bills, fund your education, or improve your home. You don't need to wait. It's true. If you're receiving a structured settlement or pension payment spread out over time and you want a lump sum amount immediately, then you need to call now. They will turn your long-term structured settlement or pension payments into a lump sum larger cash payout, so you'll get all of your money instantly. If you have a structured settlement or pension and you want cash today, call the Money Settlement Hotline right now. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. That's 888-785-0616.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. Whether you've got comments on the economic situation in Venezuela, it is not looking good as military troops have been dispatched to grocery stores to ostensibly protect the shoppers, is what the claim is. As the state's inflation rate has, it's solidly at 67%, although as Forbes points out, that's only the official inflation rate. And we know that here in the United States, the U.S. government does their best to pretend like the inflation rate is much lower than it actually
yes.
is. So what the actual inflation rate is in Venezuela is up to anybody to take a shot at, but even the official rate is a ridiculous number. And just try to imagine living in a situation where you're getting a paycheck and then a matter of a day later, that paycheck doesn't buy the same thing that it would have bought if you had cashed it that same day.
What happened in Zimbabwe when they had their hyperinflation, you would walk into a grocery store with bags of money. Literally bags of money, and it would not buy you the amount of food you were hoping when you left the store as what it would have when you walked into the store.
Do you know what the rate was at that time?
I believe the official rate was
over 100% or something like that.
500, maybe 1,000% officially.
Right. So that's what we're talking about right now, is how bad things are out there and the insanity of the price controls. Not only are they putting price controls on products in the country and nationalizing industries, taking over stores. There was a story we read like a year ago about how they nationalized some electronic stores. They went in there and I don't know if they completely nationalized them, but they forced price controls on them. And they're doing the same thing here. Of course, there's more to say about it. We'll get into that here, but your calls come first. So let's go to the phones where we have Jason on the line listening in Colorado. Jason, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Danica, and Daryl.
Yeah, hi. I know it's kind of an old subject, but I was referring to wanted to say something about the basketball coach who owned the Spurs or LA Clippers.
I'm not familiar with this. What is this? Is this like that racist basketball coach from earlier in 2014?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sterling,
yeah.
he was the owner of the team.
Yeah.
The
thing I wanted to say was I just think that, you know, I just feel like, you know, that situation was looked at totally different. And, you know, the media and everybody got right on it and everything. I mean, despite the side taking the racist issue out of the thing. I mean, I just think, like, you know, it was a private conversation, and even though his opinion's messed up, you know what I mean? I think that, you know, I mean, he doesn't have, in America, you have to treat everybody with equality, you know what I mean? But now we're talking about a guy, not even though I don't agree with his comments or what he thinks or whatnot, having the freedom to think his own thoughts in a private conversation that he has, you know, it lose all his stuff. I mean, even if I was a black person, I would feel like, you know, when Kanye West got up and said that thing about Taylor Swift, I didn't like what he had to say or whatever, you know what I mean? But, I mean, or whatnot. But,
well, just because you have freedom of speech doesn't mean that you should be immune from consequences.
Right, and additionally, the NBA
has the ability to mean, to have his own thoughts. I mean, if he treated somebody different because of the color of their skin, that's one thing. But a guy he could sit there and think whatever he wants. I mean, he's got the right to think whatever he wants, even though I don't agree with it.
He wasn't thinking what he wanted. He spoke. He spoke his thoughts into the world, and then somebody recorded him saying those things. And
the NBA, which is the National Basketball Association, The NBA, which is the National Basketball Association, they have guidelines and criteria of professionalism that all of the basketball owners must adhere to. And if they don't adhere to that, then the NBA can do a couple of things. They can either tell the owner, you have to sell the team, you can't own it anymore, or the extreme, they could say, okay, your team no longer exists in our organization.
Wow, that's pretty good.
And they did the former. They told him, you know, you have to sell the team, you don't meet the standards anymore. And, you know, instead of getting rid of an entire franchise, they found it easier to, you know, find a new owner for the team.
Jason, you're back. Go ahead.
I understand that. I just think that, you know, in America, even though we don't like what other people might think in their own private thoughts, that, you know, the worst thing that could have happened to him is his stuff come out on the air and he would have reaped the own consequences of his own actions and his own words anyway.
And one of the consequences was the NBA told him he had to sell his team.
Right, and his reputation got ruined as well, and he deserved it. Thank you, Jason, for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're actually going to have Lionel on the show tomorrow night, if all goes as planned, who is one of my favorite talk show hosts from years past. He's not an active host on talk radio anymore, but he does his own YouTube videos, and he's been really just hard. I mean, he's been hitting the Charlie Hebdo issue fairly heavily, and he's pointed out that this magazine, and I'm sure he'll explain this better tomorrow night, but this magazine is a very hateful magazine.
Yes.
This isn't just, you know, innocent cartoons that this company publishes. For people to say that they are Charlie Hebdo is essentially akin to saying, you know, that they're with the KKK or something like that. It's that level of hate and bigotry. So it'll be interesting to have Lionel get his comments, because we haven't really talked about the whole Charlie Hebdo thing here on Free Talk Live. We've been more focusing on Silk Road and Ross Ulbricht trial and things like that. So, yeah, I mean, I don't feel sorry for that team owner.
No, not one bit.
No, I mean, I just, you know, like you said, you do have freedom of speech, but there are certainly consequences that come with it. And, you know, let's not forget what the NBA is mostly made of. I mean, that was just a very... very poor judgment of him.
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. So we were sharing with you the story from Bloomberg.com about grocery shelves in Venezuela looking a little sparse. There are people who are lined up outside of the stores. One lady says she's been looking for she's looked at six stores in one day. She couldn't find any detergent, and she cleans for a living. She's a janitor, so she can't even clean her own shirt, let alone clean whatever it is she's trying to clean as far as stores.
Dare I say that the shelves of the North Korean grocers are probably better stocked?
That is a good question, Daryl.
Many of them are not for sale.
Well, unfortunately, we can't get cameras into the North Korean groceries to really understand what the situation is like there, if they even have grocery stores.
Well, remember the one Vice documentary where they went over with Dennis Rodman for the basketball thing? They were taken into some sort of shopping mall grocery sort of thing, and all of the shelves, they had, you know, the line of product, but it was only one product deep.
Right, it was a show store.
Yeah, they couldn't actually buy anything.
Yeah, a lot of it wasn't for sale.
It was just for show. So here's the remainder of the story from Bloomberg.com. A dearth of foreign currency, exacerbated by collapsing oil prices, has led to shortages of imports from toilet paper to car batteries. And they say now that annual inflation is 64% as of November. Government officials met with representatives from supermarket chains to guarantee supplies, as though a government bureaucrat sitting down with the executives from the supermarket chain is going to somehow solve their supply line problems. Like, look, if I were these supermarket chain owners, of course, you know, you're in Venezuela, so you better do what the government says. But ideally, I would tell the government to go pound sand while I called more suppliers and actually tried to find supplies rather than sitting with these people.
To put the 67% inflation into perspective, the official inflation rate in the United States is roughly 1.5%. The official inflation numbers show that there's been a 97% decline in the value of the dollar over the last 100 years.
That's right.
So you're looking at that decline every year and a half in Venezuela.
So the toll-free number here, thank you for that. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Inside a Plan Suarez grocery store yesterday in Caracas, shelves were mostly bare, while the government's claiming that the stores are full. 855-450-FREE.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. Congress is given legislative power by Article 1 of the Constitution. Congress's powers are limited, but they are vitally important. Congress can tax, raise an army, pass immigration laws, but if a power isn't listed or clearly indicated by the Constitution, Congress may not act. The 10th Amendment reiterates this point. Powers not delegated by the Constitution remain with the states or with the people. This fact may often be difficult to see given the powers Congress claims for itself. Consider interstate commerce. Congress does regulate it, but they have interpreted this power so broadly that they now strictly control transactions that aren't interstate or commerce. That's not what our nation's founders intended. It's not even in the text of the Constitution. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE and join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm if you are enjoying the program and you want to help support Free Talk Live. One of the ways you can do that is by shopping with us. You go to shop.freetalklive.com. Once again, that is shop.freetalklive.com. And that's where you can enter into Amazon, where you'll find all kinds of great deals. A regular Amazon awesomeness that you're used to. It's just that a cut of the sale will go to Free Talk Live when you start your shopping there at shop.freetalklive.com. Something else you can get through our website, which you cannot get at Amazon, is BuzzBox Coffee. Coffee.freetalklive.com is where you can go to get a free pound. All you have to do is pay the shipping cost. It's 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica, and shade grown. It's excellent coffee, but find out for yourself. Just pay that shipping cost. You'll get a free pound shipped right to your door. Coffee.freetalklive.com. You can cancel your subscription at any time. So you've got nothing to lose. Plus, when you buy your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, a portion of the profits goes to microloans to help people in really tough parts of the world make a better life for themselves. So once again, that's coffee.freetalklive.com. We're talking about Venezuela, and Tommy in Glasgow has some comments via Skype. Hello, Tommy.
Yeah, they may take your lives, but they'll never take your Free Talk Live. How you doing, lads?
Tommy, good evening, or good morning to you, I guess, at this point. It's past midnight there. What's on your mind tonight?
Yes, it's 10 to 1 in the morning, yeah. I'm just driving about Glasgow.
Uh-oh.
A bit of snow has fallen. It's a bit icy, a bit treacherous conditions, but it's all fun. Yeah, what I was phoning regards was to pass on some knowledge that I have on Venezuela.
Sure.
My young cousin, he was born there. He was a young Venezuelan, but his father, who my uncle, he works for a major oil company. When he qualified with a first-class honours from a Glasgow university, he moved on to work for one of the major oil companies. I'll remain nameless, but he left very quickly when Hugo Chavez took power. And he didn't have good words to say about Hugo Chavez. But for myself, I always had a bit of a ribbon match with him, if you like, a bit of fun, you know, because I thought, well, Hugo Chavez, what he did was similar to what Iran did when the Iranian Revolution, you know, when the Shah of Iran, who was a despot and was controlling the oil, when Iran decided, you know, we want to nationalize our oil and take back which is rightfully ours, and then they were placed with sanctions. And the same thing happened to Venezuela. As soon as he declared, he said, well, you know, look, what we're going to do, we're going to take more of our oil because it's our country's oil. And so what happened...
Well, that's nonsense, Tommy. I mean, the government doesn't own the oil. And when
Hold on. If a company, if a country has defaulted, for example, the World Bank and IMF, through the structural adjustment loans, if a country defaulted on a loan, then that the World Bank and IMF would then start to dictate the terms and conditions of what is placed on it. And multinational oil companies, along with other multinational fruit companies and multinational, you name it, when a country defaults, then basically the rights or the assets or the resources, they go through bankruptcy proceedings, and then they're dictated to from outside how much assets they can have. And so when Hugo Chavez had took over a bankrupt Venezuela, it was already bankrupt for 10, 20 years before that through the machinations of the World Bank and IMF. You can all check it out. Head of the World Bank at the time, Robert McNamara, who came through the State Department of your own country, and when he got a hold of the World Bank, these structural adjustment loans meant that the countries would never get out of this debt cycle burden. And so the multinational corporations had took control from Venezuela. And so when Hugo Chavez says, you know, hold on, we're going to stop this straight away. And as I say, my uncle, he had to leave that country, flee that country, because his company that he was working with was chased out. Now, you might think that is wrong, right, because it was the capitalist system. But if the people are not benefiting at all, you know, at all. If the resources from the land have been stripped from it and the people have got nothing.
Plenty of people benefited from the existence of the companies in Venezuela by the fact that they had jobs. And then
the fact that
if you think that people are going to benefit because the government takes over a company, you're in for a surprise because the government can't manage for garbage.
But hold on, the sanctions for a long time, right? Venezuela was able to produce a lot more for its people, and you know, the infrastructure of the country improved, and then you found that despite attempts. Some by CIA attempts to assassinate him and have a coup d'etat, the people realized that, hold on, their conditions are improving bit by bit. The conditions of the Venezuelan over a period of 10, 15 years improved. And even despite the sanctions placed on it, illegal sanctions by United States and other countries, because if a country wanted to do trade with Venezuela, if the United States didn't like it, then it would say, hold on, if you trade with that country, then we're going to ban trade with you. So then you found, and Venezuela found, the limited people that it was able to trade with. And so the only countries it could trade with, maybe Russia, Iran, or Cuba. So it found a limited resource pool. And so this is what's caused the problem now, is because, you call it geopolitics, but you can engineer the oil price to a level where it goes up to over $100, and you can engineer it to go down to less than $50. And for the oil-producing nations, this has caused a catastrophe. Now, Saudi Arabia is rich and oil-rich, and they can get over it, but when Venezuela has run a program of spending on its infrastructure that was totally against the grain the World Bank and IMF placed on it, but Hugo Chavez says, no, we're not going to suffer anymore. So they spent hugely on a program of health, of education, of road building and infrastructure that the country had never seen before and needed. And that's why I say for a period of 10, 15 years, it benefited greatly. But through the effects of geopolitics.
Which period was that? Which 10 or 15 years are you talking about?
Because the period of Hugo Chavez. The period of Hugo Chavez, where you found, if you look to the period before
The country was in the junker when Hugo Chavez died.
Exactly, exactly. And so that's what I'm saying. The multinational corporations had left it, a bankrupt nation, and they were able to do as they pleased, as they can do in any country. When the World Bank has bankrupt a nation, it can then dictate, you know, and send in slave labor shops for you.
So wait, I don't understand. You're saying that there was all these glory days in Venezuela under Hugo Chavez.
No, there wasn't glory days. It was a case of they were maybe able to spend a wee bit more. He started directing some more money into the economy. There was
never
going
to
get
it. Wasn't it not Hugo Chavez who froze the exchange rate as well on the bolivar?
Yeah, well, that's because it was pegged to a dollar, and for a time it was able to do that, and they were able to withstand it. But then, obviously, the pressure of the world's largest superpower placing sanctions on it.
No, that's not what it is. It's the problem with meddling with the economy. I mean, that causes all kinds of unintended consequences. If you manually set an exchange rate with, you know, your governmental power, the market doesn't care about that, and it's just going to go right around that as it's doing in the black market and set its own black market rate. But then as a result, there's all kinds of just horrifying consequences, which, you know, ultimately leads to no toilet paper in the country. I mean, these guys don't have toilet paper.
Hold on, use the bolivars as toilet paper. It's almost worthless anyway.
I mean, it sounds like you are pumping up this dictator as though he did something for the people in Venezuela.
Hold on. You say dictator. He was elected. He's dead now. He died a few years ago of cancer, but he was elected.
So was Saddam Hussein. That doesn't make him any less of a dictator.
But yeah, socialism just doesn't work, Tommy. I mean, you can blame
George Bush.
Hold
on. So are you saying capitalism works?
I don't know how you would define capitalism.
George Bush was elected twice. Did he elect himself fairly, or do you think those elections were rigged? Do you think he was voted in a fair way? Because from the outside, the hanging chads, his brother in Florida, then, you know, there's a case to say that he was a dictator for those 8 years.
He wanted to be a dictator.
I'm no fan of George Bush. It was a dictatorship, so long as I was the dictator.
Yeah,
to answer the question...
George Bush, but, But who's the dictator of America? The multinational corporations dictate to the American people. So America has got a dictatorship. It's just you don't call it a dictatorship. The fraud is that there's a democracy, say. It's a democracy. No, Malcolm X called it nothing but disguised hypocrisy. And you know that yourselves. You have not got a democracy there. It's a dictatorship and it's run by the elites. The less than 1%, you know you have got a dictatorship. So whether you call them Saddam Hussein or Hugo Chavez or George Bush,
they're all the same to me. At least in the United States, there's a little bit more of a semblance of economic freedom in comparison to Venezuela. Thank you, Tommy, for the call.
Now,
Darryl,
to answer his question, he asked if I thought that George Bush was elected fairly, and I will answer by saying this, that I don't think that any elections are fair, because elections are rigged from the beginning when you have all sorts of requirements that give preferential treatment to Republicans and Democrats and harm the independent and minor party candidates. They're not fair from the beginning, and it doesn't really matter who winds up winning in the end. They're not fair to begin with.
Ugh, cold winter weather. It makes my skin so dry, itchy, and irritated. Can I get some help, please, for this winter skin of mine?
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing has the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available. Its 7 moisturizers help heal skin, so you'll stop itching and start feeling relief fast.
Ah, my skin feels like it's been on vacation, even with 10 inches of snow outside.
Itch-free, worry-free, Cortisone 10. Use as directed.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, January 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.15 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,268 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $210. Antiwar.com reports a pair of U.S. drone strikes have killed 13 people in Pakistan's tribal areas, with 7 killed in a dawn attack on a North Waziristan house and 6 more killed in a second strike in South Waziristan. None of the slain in either attack was identified by name, though Pakistani officials predictably labeled everyone a suspected terrorist. 2 were said to be ethnic Uzbeks. Conspicuously, the Pakistani government has offered no criticism of the recent flurry of U.S. drone strikes, after the strikes had ground to a halt in the wake of Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif's election and loud criticism of the campaign. In recent months, the U.S. has escalated the attacks back to pre-election levels, and Pakistani officials aren't even offering the token complaints they were before. This suggests that, despite the massive unpopularity of the attacks among Pakistani voters, yet another Pakistani government has a secret understanding about the U.S. campaign. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports the United States announced sweeping new rules on Thursday that will significantly ease sanctions on Cuba, opening up the communist-ruled island to expanded U.S. travel, trade, and financial activities. Defying hardline critics in Congress, President Obama made good on his commitment last month to loosen restrictions on dealing with Cuba as part of a historic effort to end decades of hostility. The U.S. embargo on Cuba, in place for 54 years, will remain. Only Congress can lift it. But the package of regulations issued by the Treasury and Commerce Departments, which will take effect on Friday, will allow U.S. exports of telecommunications, agricultural, and construction equipment, permit more travel by Americans to the island, and open banking relations. Airlines in the United States will be permitted to expand flights to the Caribbean island beyond the existing chartered flights that connect Cuba and the United States. United Airlines said on Thursday it planned to serve Cuba from Houston and Newark, New Jersey, subject to government approval. Delta and JetBlue said they would look into adding services. Thursday's moves were the first tangible U.S. steps to implement economic changes Obama pledged on December 17th when he and Cuban President Raul Castro announced plans to restore diplomatic relations between the old Cold War foes. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Wired reports, long before the Department of Homeland Security set its sights on Ross Ulbricht, the agency had another surprising suspect in mind as the possible creator and administrator of the Silk Road's massive online drug market. Mark Karpeles, the chief executive of what was then the world's biggest Bitcoin exchange, Mt. Gox. In response to cross-examination by the defense in Ulbricht's trial yesterday, DHS Special Agent Jared Duryegyan revealed that in 2012 and 2013, he had pursued Karpeles as the suspected owner and operator of the Silk Road. He had also pursued Karpeles' Mt. Gox associate, Ashley Barr, as the voice of the Dread Pirate Roberts, the Silk Road's figurehead. Duryegyan confirmed he had even gone so far as to seek a warrant to search Karpeles' Gmail account based on probable cause that the Mt. Gox owner had secretly administered the Silk Road in a bid to boost the price of Bitcoin and, with it, his own substantial cryptocurrency fortune. In an August 2013 affidavit written by Duryegyan and read aloud by Ulbricht's defense attorney, Joshua Dreitel, Duryegyan wrote, "I believe this evidence shows Karpeles controlled SilkRoadMarket.org and the Tuxtel website and hosted them both at IP addresses he controlled," adding he thought Karpeles was well-suited to create an e-commerce site such as the Silk Road Underground website. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
We're being attacked by news from all sides in tonight's News Blitz. Now we're homing in on Houston, Texas, where NASA announced today that the crew of the International Space Station has successfully completed their 13-year mission studying man's ability to constantly repair a large object in space. NASA officials hailed the remarkable feat of maintenance at a press conference this afternoon.
And throughout human history, man has gazed at the stars and dreamed of fixing something up there. People once thought the ultimate feat in human repair was a really big boat. Today, we've accomplished so much more.
This comes in the wake of NASA's previous success, finding out how many times an astronaut could hold something in his hand, then let it go, watch it float in front of his face for a bit, then catch it again. All right, dust yourself off. You have survived the News Blitz.
Tune in tomorrow morning to Today Now. We'll look back at Jim's week as a polygamist.
Oh, it's going to be fun.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we have Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. With you in studio, it's me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And if you're just tuning in, last hour, the very end of the hour, we had Tommy in Glasgow call in because we'd been discussing Venezuela and just the ridiculous economic situation that they're in. And Tommy called in and he really laid the blame, it seemed like. And, you know, he was really going off, so it was kind of hard to follow because he's got a thick accent and all that. But I think I kind of got the gist of what he was saying, and that was that the country is in bad shape because of the terrible multinational corporations, and that Hugo Chavez was some sort of a hero who came in to, you know, nationalize the various different corporations.
Well, not just the multinational corporations, but also the IMF. And I can't disagree that the IMF is a horrible entity. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's one of these things. It's a combination of you've got the IMF trying to screw people over. You've got Hugo Chavez, who definitely was not a, you know, good person as far as, you know, political leaders go. Mm. But, you know, you've got these other outside influences, and Hugo Chavez just made those worse.
Let's go to Rod. He's calling from Canada via Skype. Rod, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, guys. I was born in Venezuela, and my parents still live in Venezuela. And unfortunately, Tommy is misinformed. The socialists, the Chavez people, have just made the situation much worse. Poverty has increased. There's awful shortages. Granted, the transnational companies were not saints. They were not, you know, really, I mean, they were corporatists, right? But the situation now is much worse.
And when did you get out of Venezuela?
A very long time ago, maybe right after Chavez was first elected the first time. So maybe, I don't know, 20 years ago or something like that. And I actually, back then, I was a socialist, and I actually voted for Chavez myself.
Did you have any options on the ballot other than Chavez?
Yeah, there were many, many parties there, many options. And back then, the elections were counted manually with paper ballots. And there were, you know, international sort of witnesses that would come and see what was going on. And in the last couple elections, they have done it all via computer, and the software is not open source. Mm-hmm. So it is believed that they're rigging all the elections inside the computer system, and they just do whatever they want.
Well, the current guy, Nicolas Maduro, was essentially Chavez's right-hand man who's now taken over the country.
Right.
So what you're saying is Tommy seems to be subscribing to some sort of a fantasy version of what actually happened.
Oh, absolutely. The country is much worse. Like, there is absolutely no comparison. The personal liberties, economic liberties, like economic well-being for everybody, not just for the rich, but for everybody. There are staple products in Venezuela. For example, cornmeal. There is a cornbread that is made everywhere across Venezuela called arepa. And the flour for this cornbread was always made privately and successfully and cheaply by private companies. And now there's shortages of even that basic staple. You can't find it. The factories have fled, and now they're operating in Colombia. I mean, the whole thing is just a huge mess. And they're more corrupt than ever. I mean, the people in government are always the same. They have always been corrupt in Venezuela, but these guys are they're just incredibly corrupt. They all have villas in South Florida. They all, you know, they go to special restaurants where they won't be, harassed. You know, they have their own clubs. They wear, you know, Rolex watches, and it's just opulence left and right.
How much time do you think they have left? I mean, now there's an article over at Forbes saying that the collapse is impending, given that the, you know, the oil prices are nowhere near what they were, and that's, of course, a major staple that is benefiting, you know, the state there.
I don't know what to say. They've been saying that the collapse is impending for the last decade.
Hmm.
And the same happened with Cuba. You know, it's amazing how bad things can get.
Yeah.
You know,
and still
and
get
people
worse.
People will just take it, you know.
Well, what are they going to do? I mean, how do people know what to do anything besides go and vote for some other scumbag? I mean, how?
Exactly. They think that voting harder will get them somewhere. And they're dreaming about this, you know, great man that's going to come and save them, you know. It's not going to happen that way. They're not taking control.
Good call tonight, man. Thanks for the follow-up there.
Thank you as well.
Nothing like hearing from somebody who's actually been there, and as you said, you still have family living down there. So anything you hear, any stories you want to share anytime, don't hesitate to call us. Thanks, Rod. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, you know, as usual with the socialist presidents, you know, like Maduro now or Hugo Chavez before him, there's this narrative about how they're for the people, you know, and that's how they get themselves elected. They promise things to the people, and then ultimately they just aggrandize themselves and, you know, give themselves BMWs and Rolexes, as he was talking about, all the while talking about how it's not his fault. It's not his fault why things are in the crap can in Venezuela. It's the multinational corporations. It's the U.S. federal government. It's all these other things. Even in North Korea, the claim is that the reason why there's no power a lot of the time is because the U.S. government is constantly attacking the brave North Korean military. They're defending the country constantly from U.S. attack, but sometimes those U.S. strikes will hit too close to home and the power will go out. So it's not because North Korea's a communist nation and they, you know, they don't have any economic incentive to provide power because there's no competition or anything like that. No, that's not the reason. It's because they're under attack from the United States. So it sounds like the same excuses coming out of Venezuela. Oh, it's not our fault. It's the U.S. government. It's these sanctions. And I'm not saying I'm for sanctions. I'm not. And I'm certainly not a fan of huge multinational corporations either, but nationalizing multinational corporations isn't going to make things better.
Right.
More to the story here, or from the story at Bloomberg.com, is about the supermarket shortages going on there, where people are having trouble finding basics like chicken or detergent, toilet papers. Inside a Plan Suarez grocery store yesterday in eastern Caracas, shelves were mostly bare. Customers struggled and fought for items at times, with many trying to skip the lines. The most sought-after products included detergent, with customers waiting in line for 2 to 3 hours to buy a maximum of 2 bags. A security guard asked that photos of empty shelves not be taken. Police inside a Luvebras supermarket in eastern Caracas intervened to help staff distribute toilet paper and other products. So you've got cops handing out toilet paper to customers in Venezuela. Jean-Paul Mate, a meat vendor, said outside the Luvebras store, quote, "You can't find anything. I've spent 15 days looking for diapers. You have to take off work to look for products. I go to at least 5 stores per day." Venezuelan online news outlet Vivo Play posted a video of government food security regulator Carlos Osorio being interrupted by throngs of shoppers searching for products as he broadcast on state television from a Bicentenario government-run supermarket. Government-run supermarket in central Caracas. Quote, "What we're seeing is worse than usual. It's not only a seasonal problem. Companies are not sure how they will restock their inventories or find merchandise, with a looming fear of a devaluation. The price for Venezuela's oil, which accounts for more than 95% of the country's exports, has plunged by more than half from last year's peak in June to $47 a barrel." So they used to get over $100 a barrel. It's $47 a barrel as of this
month.
What
a drop.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We'll come back with more on the Venezuelan situation. You can share your thoughts with us here and join us via Skype. It's Skype username lrn.fm or Free Talk Live coming up.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project. It's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Things are bad and maybe getting worse in Venezuela. It's an interesting study in the failure of socialism, although lots of people like to point fingers at a lot of different things. As we've heard tonight, Tommy in Glasgow said he thinks it's the multinational corporations' fault. But unfortunately, the government stands in the way. Look, I'm no fan of multinational corporations, but I'm even less of a fan
of nationalization of companies. And just because I oppose socialism doesn't mean I'm a capitalist. I don't really even know what that word means. I think it's a word that means different things to different people. And so I would not assign myself that particular term. I like the idea of a free market where if somebody wants to engage in voluntary communism, that's fine by me. If you want to live on a commune and you want to throw all of your crops or whatever into a central storehouse and divvy them up equally to everybody living on the commune, regardless of the amount of effort they put in to actually creating that, then that's, you know, that's your business, as long as you aren't forcing anyone into it. But I like the idea of a free marketplace. And of course, we don't have that in the United States. Nobody has that anywhere in the entire world. By the way, it's Ian here with you tonight.
And Danica.
And Daryl.
Check out Daryl's website, fpp.cc. There's some written Daryl there in book form and in newspaper form and just plain old internet blog article form.
Yes.
But also fppradio.com is where you can get audio of Daryl, including the thrice weekly production, about a half hour per episode. Is that right? Peace, Love,
yes.
Liberty Radio?
30 minutes, three times a day. Peace, Love, Liberty Radio. There's also the daily 5-minute newscast that I have been doing with only a 3-day interruption 7 days a week since February of last year.
So we were talking about the insanity in Venezuela, where people are waiting in lines for some of the basics, according to a man named Grisly Harpe, 42-year-old data analyst, excuse me, say female. She says, this is the worst it has ever been. I've seen lines thousands of people long. People are so desperate. She says she's waiting for dish soap. People are so desperate, they are sleeping in the lines. So this is like, you know, the total reverse of Black Friday, where people are actually waiting in lines because they're excited to get products that are in, you know, plentiful stock to some extent. Here, people are waiting in lines and sleeping, camping out because they want to be able to clean their dishes.
Weren't there long lines in the 70s for gas, too?
There were in the United States.
Yes.
Yeah.
And they had price controls at that time, I believe.
Yes.
Which is, of course, one of the reasons why shortages can happen if there's price controls, because when price controls are put into place, then that encourages buying that wouldn't necessarily otherwise happen. So, for instance, a classic example of this is after a hurricane, if a state demands that a convenience store cannot charge more than $1 per bag of ice, whereas the convenience store would normally charge $5 per bag or $10 per bag, the allegation from the state is that the convenience store is gouging its customers. But what really happens is if it's $10 per bag, then the person who's coming into the store who needs the ice to keep some sort of medical supplies cold is going to pay the $10, whereas the person who just wants to keep his beer cold is probably not as likely to pay the $10 because it's just not that important. So
right.
Having differing pricing, depending on what's going on in the marketplace, allows for consumers and businesses to make the optimal choice.
And something else that you'll see whenever this happens to where, you know, the temporary price controls go into effect is that the prices increase elsewhere across the country on, like, gas, for instance, mm-hmm. will increase in other parts of the country so that the gas company can make up the difference of the amount of money that they're basically losing because of the price control in a certain area.
Mm-hmm. Right. And when
I guess you could say reverse gouging, to where they're increasing the price in the place where there's not the increased demand.
Mm-hmm. Well, the government's not paying as close attention there, right? So they can more easily increase the price in those other areas without having the bureaucrats come down on their heads.
Right, but the reason they're doing it is to make up
for it, yeah,
because of the control in a certain area.
So if you don't have, or if you have price control, so if the government implements the $1 price control for, let's say, a bag of ice, then whoever wants to buy all of the ice will just come in there and buy it up. I mean, they can buy as much ice as they'd like, and then maybe the person who was going to come in to try to keep the insulin cold or whatever, they don't have any ice left because the last guy bought it all.
Well, the guy that bought it all will probably go stand on a street corner somewhere
and
sell
it for
$10. $10.
Yeah, because he's willing to take the risk, whereas the business owner is much more cautious towards that.
Yes.
So that's one example of price controls. Nick is in Cleveland. You're on Free Talk Live, Cleveland, Ohio. Hello, Nick.
Hi. How do you guys think that guy voted on the Scottish referendum? I'm curious.
He voted for independence. We actually talked to Tommy about that.
Oh, Oh, you did. Okay.
Yeah, most of the time, Tommy sounds friendly to freedom ideas, but today he definitely did not.
Yeah, I was surprised to hear that.
Well, anyway, my question was on the Venezuelan situation. I'm looking at some Reddit feeds that are talking about how, you know, Venezuela might become the first country to sort of adopt Bitcoin as its national currency because of this inflation. And I see this as highly unlikely.
Seems like pie in the sky
to
me.
Sorry, what'd you say?
I said that seems pretty pie in the sky to me.
Yeah, I mean, I think if there's a better alternative, you know, if the dollar is more stable than Bitcoin, which it is still, they're going to use dollars.
Oh, right? I don't think they would adopt the dollar in Venezuela. I mean, the United States is evil, right? Like they.
No. I mean,
no, he's not saying officially. He's saying just. The people is sort of de facto sort of thing.
Oh, dollars are worth quite a bit in Venezuela. As we were pointing out earlier, the official exchange rate is 6.3 bolivars per dollar, but in the black market, you can get as much as 187. Now, that's unlikely that you're going to get that because whoever it is you're going to sell the dollar to will want to resell it to someone else. So, you know, you might get 60 to 80 bolivars.
I actually saw a chart on Wikipedia where it was showing the unofficial exchange rate.
Mm-hmm.
And the most recent update, I believe, was from December or November of last year, showed it at about 150 bolivars, $2.
And wow, it has doubled then since the last time we talked about this, which was at some point in mid-2014. So yeah, go ahead, Nick.
Yeah, I mean, and the other thing I guess I wanted to ask was, in this context with Bitcoin, do you guys see a full-on ban on Bitcoin coming in the United States? Because I see several.
No. Oh, I know. Absolutely not.
No. I feel like Peter Thiel, for example, has predicted this. Martin Armstrong, who's this guy who's famous for having predicted the crash of 87, he's kind of a Peter Schiff-like character, has called for this. I mean, I didn't think that this was going to happen, but I'm surprised to see that there are several people out there now who are well-respected who are saying that this might happen.
No, and there's actually legislation in New Hampshire that would prevent the banking regulators in New Hampshire from regulating any virtual currency.
That's proposed. It's not
right.
Hasn't passed yet. But yeah, I mean, we've got a really robust, I think, Bitcoin universe here in New Hampshire. There's a lot of Bitcoin folks up here, and you're going to see that positiveness toward Bitcoin trickle into the government here due to the Free State Project and the people that are active. Of course, if they ban it at the national level, then obviously, you know, we'll have to cross that bridge when we come to it. But I haven't heard any such rumblings, Nick. The only rumblings that I've heard of are the proposal to highly regulate Bitcoin exchanges in New York State. And, of course, that would be terrible, but it's certainly not a ban. I thank you for the call tonight. There's more coming up here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More on the way. Free Talk Live.
For the last 2 years, I've been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to design a nutraceutical formulation that has truly life-changing health benefits. So many other formulations out there contain toxic ingredients, synthetic additives, and even GMOs. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
I'm getting joined by Ellie Granderson. She's going to put a feminine scope on these lace kerchief star buggers and give us her lady opinion. Ellie?
Hi, Joe.
You know, it riles me up every time you walk in here, Ellie. You set my blood to dancing with all your pillowy parts.
Oh, stop it, Joe.
Now, give it to me, no fimble famble, Ellie. When we start dusting these rocket boys' lily white bottoms with baby puff?
Joe, since the end of the Cold War, NASA has basically functioned as a giveaway to the American aerospace industry, wasting trillions of taxpayer dollars every year on extravagant programs with no tangible benefits.
Fine as a plum to look at, all the sense of a badger to boot.
Joe.
Now I've been thinking on, and I got these three little chickens pecking on my head, we'll save NASA some coin. Man wants to go to space, can strap on a helmet, climb in the cannon, let the Chinese gunpowder carry him off among the stars. He'll come back now. Gonna skin a fox in one throat, and you're gonna fancy on it.
This is the Onion News Network.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial in here toll-free, bring up anything you'd like, 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. With you in studio, it's Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
If you care about your online privacy, you need to know about ProXPN. They are a global virtual private network, the important word being private. They encrypt your internet connection, so your internet service provider will no longer know what you're doing. Right now, they're probably saving your entire surfing history, including the search terms that you enter, the websites you visit, and that's a violation. You don't have to put up with that. You can go to proxpn.com/FTL. Download their free software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices. You get it installed, and you're protected from your own internet service provider snooping on you. Now, there's more that ProXPN offers. Now, when you get their premium account, you'll get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can connect to. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. You can do it all by going to proxpn.com/FTL. And then remember promo code FTL50. The 50 stands for 50% off, which is 50% off the annual account. And that'll be locked in for you. That discount will be locked in for the lifetime of your account. So go to proxpn.com/FTL and don't forget code FTL50. You get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. proxpn.com/FTL, code FTL50. We've been talking quite a bit about Venezuela tonight. It's just fascinating to watch. You know, for us out on the outside, we have the pleasure of being able to go to the grocery store and have oodles of toilet paper from multiple brands from which we can choose. 2-ply, 1-ply,
I'm still waiting for 3-ply.
They must have it somewhere, don't you think?
I've never seen it.
Well, you can make your own, Daryl, if you really, really care.
Yeah.
Are you picky with how, since we're on the subject of toilet paper, are you picky about it going over the top or under the bottom? I'm just curious.
Over the top. It's got to go over the top.
I don't understand why people are so
Everybody
picky
else
about
is
it.
Wrong.
Like it under the bottom?
I don't even pay attention.
Oh, my God. You can't tear it off if it goes under the bottom.
I really don't pay attention.
You have
like
to
they're
use,
the same
you,
thing.
If it goes under the bottom, you have to use two hands to tear. You have to use one hand to hold the roll and then the other hand to tear it off, whereas if you have it rolling over the top...
I should not have asked this question. What have I done?
If you
there are two kinds of people. Those that put toilet paper on the thing going over and those people that are wrong.
Honestly, I just don't even pay attention. So it could be top, it could be bottom. Who knows?
I actually removed the toilet paper roll from the LRN studios. So now you just have to pick up the roller thing.
Yes.
Now you just actually have to pick up the entire roll of toilet paper at this point.
And then you can hold it whichever way you want.
Works best. Yeah. So,
but you're still wrong.
Wait, who's wrong? Danica, right?
No, you, because you don't have it on the roll going down.
No, there's no roller. There's no roller at all.
Right, so therefore you're wrong.
So I should install a roll? Is that where a roller? Is that what you're saying?
I'm not saying you should do anything. I'm just saying
you're
wrong.
It's easier. In the way the LRN studio bathroom is set up, it's easier to actually have it where you can hold it in your hand.
Yes.
Because it's awkward to actually have to turn because the wall's so close to you. And it's like,
and the sink is right in front of the toilet.
It's the most uncomfortable toilet. Yeah. Really.
It is a very tiny bathroom.
It's not very, very nice to be in the LRN bathrooms. But moving on. So we were talking about Venezuela here at Yahoo.com. They've got an updated story because the story about the grocery stores having military protection to ostensibly protect the customers from one another because they are fighting over things like what toilet paper is available. The police have been involved in distributing toilet paper. People are waiting in lines for that. In one lady, and I don't know if she's exaggerating, but she says she's seen lines thousands of people long. She's seen people sleeping in those lines. She is waiting for dish soap. People are having a tough time finding the most basic staples there, and it's thanks to the government and their price controls. And the ridiculous, especially the controls on the economy with the insane exchange rate that is arbitrarily set.
Hold on. I've got a question. I just had this image in my mind of people waiting for, you know, like a day and a half to go into the grocery store.
Yes.
Presumably they're not eating while they're waiting.
Where do they urinate?
Where do they go to the bathroom?
Right. Yeah, I don't know.
While they're waiting to buy toilet paper.
Oh,
maybe somebody's driving around with a porta potty on the back of a truck and
maybe,
you know, charging 25
cents or something.
Oh, well, you said shifts, right?
Yes, shifts? I did
okay,
say
good.
Shifts.
Okay, we were just talking about the bathroom. Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, how do they deal with that? That would be an excellent question. We actually had somebody in Venezuela who could answer that for us. Feel free to call in if you have internet access. We'd love to hear from you. Skype username is lrn.fm. So another related story, this one from Reuters here in Caracas. At least a dozen protesters arrested. This one was written this week on Monday. At least a dozen protesters were arrested in Venezuela. They remained in jail on Monday, and masked assailants burned a bus amid scattered unrest over swelling lines for basic goods. Police rounded up 16 people for protesting outside stores over the weekend, according to the opposition MUD coalition, which said four of them were released shortly after. Rights group Pinal Forum said 18 protesters were still behind bars on Monday, and the government did not confirm that. Venezuela is suffering from a chronic shortage of goods, ranging from diapers to flour, that have worsened since an ebb in deliveries over Christmas. The scarcity has forced shoppers across Venezuela to line up in front of stores before dawn. The MUD is also, hasn't said what that stands for, is also accused of soldiers posted outside shops, also accused soldiers posted outside shops of banning photos of the lines, which can snake around blocks. So we know that in the last article, people in the stores have told customers to not take pictures of the empty shelves. Outside of the stores, soldiers are telling people to not take pictures of the lines. Gee, do you think they have something to hide?
MUD is the Democratic Unity Roundtable,
okay,
which in Spanish is Mesa de la Unidad Democrática.
Thank you for that. The MUD chief, Jesus Torrealba, says, quote, not only is the government forcing people to get into humiliating queues, it also wants the lines to be Cuban style, silent and terrified. On Saturday, an explosive device was thrown into a building of the state phone company, CANTV, in southeastern Puerto Ordaz City, burning eight vehicles, said the government. In western San Cristobal, six masked men threw a Molotov cocktail into a parked bus belonging to a university.
Oh, wow.
Students
That's
said.
Not going to get you toilet paper.
People are upset. National Assembly President Diosdado Cabello on Monday condemned what he called a strategy by enemies of the revolution to foment unrest in queues and called on Venezuelans to resist provocations.
Well, there was your question that you were asking about riots, Daryl. It's right there.
It's happening. Yep. While the scattered unrest is a far cry from massive demonstrations that rocked the country for 4 months in 2014, it comes amid growing frustration over the economic crisis. Presidente Nicolas Maduro, whose popularity has plunged, says right-wing agitators and Venezuela's elite are trying to topple him via an economic war. See, it's all about him.
Yes.
they are making it so the country has no toilet paper just to make him look bad. It's all the company's fault.
Those right-wingers.
Yeah.
How dare they?
I wonder if they're called Tea Partiers.
In Venezuela?
Yeah.
I don't know.
So, TPers?
At the start of this year, the parasitical oligarchy ambushed us. Oh, this is more from Maduro, who, by the way, was speaking from the safety of Saudi Arabia. He says, at the start of this year, the parasitical oligarchy ambushed us, but we and the people are responding, he said. In the last week, Maduro and his closest ministers have visited China, Russia, and other oil-producing countries to seek financing and OPEC action on tumbling oil prices. Quote, this is an emergency, said Henrique Karpeles, who lost an election to Maduro in 2013. It's an emergency, not the time for photos of Maduro doing tourism in China. I think it's time for our people to protest in the streets. Critics blame Venezuela's recession on socialist policies such as a 12-year-old exchange control system, one that fails to provide enough hard currency for imports.
And I guess the people are speaking. They're speaking by, you know, rioting and throwing Molotov cocktails at buses and standing in lines for toilet paper.
Well, think about this. How would you feel if you were the importer? Somebody who is willing to sell some toilet paper to the company or to companies there, but yet the official exchange rate is a fraction of what you can actually get for a dollar in Venezuela. You wouldn't want to make the sale. There's more coming up.
For 20 years, you've trusted Lumber Liquidators for the best deals on the best selection of floors. Well, this week, get even more deals in our January flooring sale. One beautiful hardwood? Get pre-finished solid hardwood from $189. How about gorgeous bamboo that's twice as hard as oak? We've got strand bamboo for $219. Looking for top quality laminate? This week, get almost half off our thickest and best laminate, plus other great flooring deals and 18-month special financing. Don't wait. The January flooring sale's going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the
problem, officer.
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you got to keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. Talking about the fascinating and horrifying, depending on your perspective, situation in Venezuela. Things are not getting better for the people there, and the president of the country, Nicolas Maduro, is blaming it all on everyone else. Of course, it's not his fault. It's he's under attack from everybody in the world. He's trying to do his best for his country, but darn it, it's those right-wingers and those multinational corporations in the United States, and if it weren't for all of them, then everything would just be hunky-dory there in Venezuela.
Those damn TP partiers!
So you're welcome to share your thoughts with us here tonight. If you'd like, 855-450-FREE. Plus, coming up, some shocking news out of Washington, D.C. that Daryl has regarding asset forfeiture. Like, shockingly good news.
Yes.
We'll get into that when we get the chance. Plus, the latest on the Silk Road. And, of course, your calls at 855-450-FREE. We've been we shared a story from Bloomberg.com about the lines surrounding outside of grocery stores. Some say these lines are thousands of people long. Soldiers are in the streets preventing people from taking pictures of the lines. There are people being threatened. They are not allowed to take pictures of the empty store shelves. Nicolas Maduro says that, and by the way, he's saying this from the safety of China and then Saudi Arabia, that it was the parasitical oligarchy ambushing him, and that it was right-wing agitators in Venezuela's elite that are trying to topple him via an economic war. The idea being that in order to bring down Maduro, they are shorting the country toilet paper, chicken, detergent, and other things to make the people so angry that they will displace Nicolas Maduro.
Yes.
Which seems so paranoid. I mean, if this guy actually believes the words coming out of his mouth, which I don't know if that's necessarily the case, but if he actually does believe the words coming out of his mouth, then he is super paranoid to the max.
Well, you know, you do have to start at the bottom to build a grassroots movement.
Okay. I don't get it.
Never mind.
Right. Okay. So the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Was it a joke?
I mean, yes. Toilet paper. Start at the bottom.
The bottom. Oh, yeah. That was good. Did you get it, Danica? Because I
kind of looked at him and I was just thinking, huh? And he's just, and then he just shook his head and said, never mind. I'm like,
now
okay.
It makes more sense.
Bad joke.
Okay. So let's see. So what we were saying here just a moment ago, you, Daryl, actually had a related story about smuggling, because what I was talking about is the reason why toilet paper is hard to find.
Yes.
Is because a lot of it's imported. And if you are an importer in Venezuela, then you can't do business on the up and up
You don't want to, because if you're selling your products for, I don't know what a pallet of toilet paper would cost, but right now the exchange rate in Venezuela is officially set and frozen by the government at 6.3 bolivars per U.S. dollar. So if you're coming in with a pallet full of toilet paper that you're willing to sell to some buyer in Venezuela, and that buyer is not doing business in the black market, that buyer has to, make... The grocery store, whoever, the buyer for the grocery store has to write things down officially, and they have to indicate, yeah, we bought 5 pallets of toilet paper and this was what we paid. Then the government can check on that. It's not the same as selling to somebody in the black market. So if somebody is giving this importer, they're giving them U.S. dollars to the importer. The importer can, or actually, I don't think you can officially even use dollars. If they're giving them bolivars, then those bolivars are only going to be worth 6.3 per dollar. So if the pallet of toilet paper is worth $50 or something like that, you multiply that times 6. Whereas if you were to be able to sell that pallet of toilet paper in the black market, you might get as many as 150 bolivars per dollar. So that would be a whole lot more that you could get for that toilet paper.
Yes.
So why would you want to sell the toilet paper at 6.3 per dollar when you could sell it at 150 per dollar on the black market? There's just no economic incentive to actually do business on, the up and up, so to speak, legit business. Did I explain that well? Because I'm not an economist.
Kind of.
Okay.
So Danica had asked the question about smuggling, and a quick Google search revealed an article from The Economist from last August that says Venezuela's western border is a smuggler's paradise.
Yeah, because I wasn't sure. You know what? There's all this regulation in the area of getting things there. What about going to the border and having things passed over to them? Please continue. I'm very curious.
Everything from rice to cement finds its way over the frontier into Colombia. Mm. The most lucrative trade of all is its petrol, meaning oil. Venezuela's energy minister, Rafael Ramirez, reckons the equivalent of 100,000 barrels a day is smuggled out of Venezuela.
Oh, wow.
What are the common exchanges?
That's a lot of smuggling.
That is.
That is.
The cause, they write in The Economist, is a battery of state subsidies and price controls in Venezuela, which also maintains a heavily overvalued currency. Petrol in Venezuela is so cheap that an entire 50-liter car tank, which would be equivalent to 11 gallons, can be filled for well under $1 or even less than 6 cents at the black market rate. Over the border in Colombia, it goes for $1.20 per liter. The government says it loses to smuggling 40% of the subsidized food that it supplies to state-owned grocery stores. The economic impact runs several billion dollars per year.
So the food the government is supplying to its own grocers is being smuggled to Colombia?
Yes, because people can get more money for it in Colombia.
Wow. Okay.
Because of the flat rate of 6.3 bolivars to one U.S. dollar. Mm. And in August, they said that the, 1 liter of petrol went for $1.20 in Colombia, whereas you could fill up your entire tank for less than $1 in Venezuela. Mm. The article also mentions that in August on the 11th, there was an attempt to plug the leaks. Venezuela began night closures between 10 p.m. and 5 a.m. of its 1,400-mile border with Colombia. Wow. Although it doesn't say how you close a 1,400-mile border. Heavy goods traffic in the border area is now banned for 11 hours a day. So basically, the big trucks...
Yeah,
can't cross the border for 11 hours a day.
But you said 100,000 gallons or liters or what was
barrels.
It? Barrels. 100,000 barrels of oil. are being smuggled out of Venezuela per day. That's a
That's the estimate.
That's insane. Yeah, I mean, that's just think about how many trucks that is.
And that's not even counting how much rice or anything else. And that was last summer.
I mean, to call that smuggling is almost not the right term, right? Like, smuggling suggests that you are being secretive and that you're, you know, ferreting something. Like, you've got a truck full of, you know, some other product, and in the back there's a few, you know, oil canisters.
Well, there's a picture with the article that shows a guy with three of these. You know the large chemical containers that are maybe 5 gallon barrel, might even be 10 gallon.
Yeah.
He's got three of these, one in each hand and one on his shoulders, and he's hunched over.
Geez.
And it looks like he's crossing a river. So,
insane.
You know, some of it is this low-level smuggling, and others, there's definitely stuff being taken out on trucks.
Yeah, somebody who's taken a truck of oil out can easily afford to pay whatever the border guards are going to charge to let that thing through. I mean,
the market will provide in every way.
Amazing.
Yeah, so it sounds like there is smuggling, but it's going the other way. It's not being smuggled into Venezuela because there's no money to be made.
Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, unless you can get paid in dollars and then exchange those dollars for the bolivars on the black market. Then you can live fairly well in Venezuela.
If it's costing me, let's just say it's $1 per roll of toilet paper, because that's about the price. If you go buy one roll, it's going to be about a dollar.
Yep.
I could just use my 160 bolivars as toilet paper instead of buying a roll of toilet paper on the black market.
So you're welcome to share your thoughts here. It's fascinating what's going on that way.
Or find a bucket of water.
Another story out of the AP. Venezuela crisis deepens as Maduro seeks support abroad. This was published just an hour ago. So looks like things are getting worse. We'll keep our eyes on the situation. Coming up, we'll shoot closer to home here with Daryl and the story from Washington, D.C. Eric Holder making a proclamation today or yesterday, or very recently.
It was today.
That is shocking. I have to say I'm surprised by this, and we'll explain it to you here in a moment. It has to do with asset forfeiture, one of the worst parts of the insane war on drugs. Coming up in Hour 3 on Free Talk Live.
For all of you who are inspired to create your own unique holiday cards and gifts.
For all of you, there's Vistaprint.com. At Vistaprint.com, creating personalized holiday cards is simple. Choose from hundreds of designs and add your own photos and special messages. And they're 60% off. Plus, personalized one-of-a-kind gifts are also to 60% off. It's our best deal of the season. But hurry, offer ends December 7th. The only way to get this incredible deal is to go to Vistaprint.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code RADIO60. Vistaprint.com, code RADIO, the word 60.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com.
I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, January 16th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,262. Silver at $17.05. And Bitcoin is trading around $216.58. Today's Bitcoin price is brought to you by Express Coin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at expresscoin.com. Extreme weather, from droughts lasting for weeks and torrential rainstorms robbing the country of vital crops for food, to snowstorms of 70 inches plus, stopping cities in their tracks. Supporting your family through these difficult times is what eFoods Direct does. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, the location is New York, where it was revealed during day three of the Silk Road trial that Department of Homeland Security agent Jared Duryagin, at one point in his involvement in the Silk Road investigation, suspected disgraced Mt. Gox CEO Mark Karpeles and his right-hand man, Ashley Barr, of being the masterminds behind Silk Road. His suspicions led to his signing of an affidavit stating that he had probable cause to get a warrant to search Karpeles' emails. Duryagin also expressed frustration with a parallel Baltimore, Maryland investigation that seized money from Karpeles associated with alleged illegal money transfer business, tipping him off to the fact that there was a government investigation underway. It was also revealed that Karpeles' attorney told Maryland investigators he wanted to make a deal that he would say who he thought was behind Silk Road in exchange for immunity. Karpeles, in a statement to Motherboard, denied any involvement with the Deep Web website. A federal study released by the National Academy of Sciences has concluded that there is no effective alternative to the government's practice of mass data collection of digital communications. The report said no software-based technique can fully replace the bulk collection of signals intelligence. The authors called for limits on how the data is viewed and used, but not in limiting how much information is collected. The committee behind the report said stopping or slowing data collection will deprive analysts of necessary information. Countering the report, the ACLU said supporting continued bulk data collection would be a mistake. Today's broadcast of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by WatchMyBit.com, the first ever micropayment-based video service. If you're a content creator, visit WatchMyBit.com to learn how you can use Bitcoin to generate revenue for your art. That's WatchMyBit.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 16th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. An investigation by the Washington Times has found that nonprofit organizations funded by billionaire George Soros helped fund protests in Ferguson and contributed to social media campaigns. The Times reports the Open Society Foundations gave at least $33 million in grants to a number of groups involved in grassroots activism following the shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Some groups monitored and exploited news events that they could portray as a conservative misstep. The groups use shared content and buzzwords to create a social media echo chamber of Facebook likes and Twitter hashtags that would garner media attention. Kenneth Zimmerman, the director of the Open Society Foundation's U.S. programs, said the groups were funded by Soros through the foundation, but stressed the nonprofit did not have the ability to control or dictate what others say or choose to say. The former mayor of Iguala, Mexico, has been charged in the kidnapping of 43 students who have been missing since September of 2014. Former Mayor Jose Luis Abarca Thomas Zeron, Director of Criminal Investigations at the Federal Attorney General's Office, stated that a warrant had been issued for Abarca's arrest and 44 other officials. The students' disappearance has been connected to local police working with a drug gang in collaboration with the mayor and his wife. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 16th, 2015, I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Following the conclusion of yet another day marked by a litany of tedious and unavoidable realities, The Onion spoke with sociologist Dr. Timothy Coghill, who told reporters that the nation would be forced to go through all of it again tomorrow.
As our projections demonstrate, tomorrow, like today, every man, woman, and child in America will wake up and do it all again. All of it. Including traffic, the workday, bad coffee, your kid's soccer game, laundry, the struggling economy.
Statistical evidence also showed that the nation would once again endure traumatic childhood memories, Twitter, anxiety, poverty, consumerism, rampant abuses of the legal system,
joint pain, racial inequality, global warming, the steady erosion of civil liberties, violence, loneliness, disease, unresolved intimacy issues, the ravages of age, hunger, sexual frustration, existential dread, the looming specter of death.
For more on this unending story, check this week's Onion Review.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free to bring up anything you'd like. 855-450-FREE. News that shocked me. I mean, it's hard to shock me with a good news from the government, but actually there's a little bit that Daryl is going to be telling us about here in a moment. With you tonight, it's Ian,
Danica,
and Daryl.
So we talked a lot about Venezuela in the first couple of hours of the show, but that's certainly not the only news in the world. It's just something that I like to focus on from time to time because, well, it's instructive. Socialism doesn't work, and that's yet another example in a history of terrifying examples that have resulted in death and starvation.
Can I shorten your statement, or rather correct your statement briefly to say that coercive government doesn't work?
That's a good point.
Whether it be socialism, corporatism, fascism, you know, this thing in the U.S. that they call capitalism, that, sure, you know, depending on whose definition you believe, it, you know,
Democratic,
if you go with
Republican.
Marx, then yeah, the U.S. is capitalist. If you go with Rothbard, then no, it's not.
It's fascist.
But, you know, any coercive government does not work.
Sure. It's just easier to see in Venezuela because the problems have been amplified and they're really coming to a head now. So let's talk about something a little closer to home here, Daryl. Washington, D.C., some good news.
Yes. This actually came out earlier today. Attorney General Eric Holder barred local and state police from using federal law to seize cash, cars, and other property without proving that a crime occurred. Holder's action represents the most sweeping check on police power to confiscate personal property since the seizures began three decades ago.
Wow.
As part of the war on drugs. Since 2008, thousands of local and state police agencies have made more than 55,000 seizures of cash and property.
Since 2008?
Yes.
Okay.
Worth approximately $3 billion under a civil asset forfeiture program at the Justice, or rather that the Justice Department calls equitable sharing. The program has enabled local and state police to make seizures and then have them adopted by federal agencies, which share in the proceeds. The program allowed police departments and drug task forces to keep up to 80% of the proceeds of the adopted seizures, with the rest going to federal agencies.
This just happened a few weeks ago here in Keene, New Hampshire, where the DEA was offering a spiff, basically this sharing, as they call it, to the local police department. And the city council, of course, had to approve this. So essentially, they're willing to cut a check for, I think it was 10% of the take from a couple of drug raids that happened in another county. And it was kind of interesting because, you know, it was the cops from this county who were working in this other county. And even though they're technically out of their jurisdiction, it's still legal because, well, you know, they can do whatever they
because
want.
Because they're the law.
Because
of course.
Drug war.
Yeah, and so they only got 10%, but what they actually said in the hearing was that normally they take 80%. Normally, the when the Keene police helps out the DEA or the drug task force or something like that in New Hampshire, or in Keene, New Hampshire, in this area,
then they take 80% of the take. In this case, they were only taking 10% because it was only like one of their detectives who was working on this in this other county. And so, of course, the Liberty activists went in. Me and a couple of other guys went in there and we spoke to this county or this city commission and explained to them why prohibition is a bad thing and it doesn't work. And here we are again, you know, doing prohibition all over again. And you guys shouldn't be encouraging this. Please turn this down. And of course, they voted unanimously to take it.
We'll take this $1,100.
But now what you're saying is, Daryl, that that won't be happening?
Right. Now, this does not affect any state or local laws that allow for asset forfeiture.
Okay.
This just says that the state and municipal governments can no longer use the federal law.
Without a conviction.
Without a conviction.
Meaning that, as we've seen in certain instances, if you, let's say, Danica, you've got your life savings in the bank and you want to travel somewhere and you need that life savings because you're going to go and buy a house or something like that, and you've got thousands upon thousands of dollars with you in a lockbox in your car. You get pulled over, the cops find that money, and then they just take the cash, and you don't even always get charged with something. In some cases, they'll actually charge the cash with a crime.
Right.
And then they will take the they'll use asset forfeiture proceedings to essentially convict the cash of being illegal and then confiscate the cash.
Right. And the lawsuit would not be state of New Hampshire versus Danica's cash. It would be state of New Hampshire versus the cash.
Right. Okay, but so what if I so even if I had a receipt that proves that I withdrew this, it doesn't even matter?
No, it wouldn't
no,
matter
because
at all.
You might go buy drugs with that
oh,
money.
Oh wow. Right.
So, yeah, ridiculous. It's happened a lot. It's happened to a number of people. I mean, you know, grandmothers.
There was a story that we covered not too terribly
truckers.
Long ago about the lady that owned the restaurant. And the local bank down the street said, well, it's easier for us if you make deposits, you know, of like $5,000 a couple times a week. Mm-hmm. Then we don't have paperwork. And, you know, some government agency came in and seized everything out of her savings account and she's, you know, had to borrow money to keep the restaurant afloat while she sues to try to get her money back.
That's ridiculous.
But the amount that she's spending on the lawsuit is roughly equivalent to the amount of money that she's going to get
That's
back.
That's her money.
Yeah. Not
yes,
anymore.
But because, well, the law says that if you make suspicious deposits
right,
or a deposit over $10,000.
Right, I know. I've worked in banking and you know, I've had to do several of those and it's just as uncomfortable for us as it is for, you know, the person having to do it. It's just it's totally and utterly ridiculous. Like it's just there's no use for it.
So you filled out suspicious activity reports?
Unfortunately, I had to and you know, couldn't let the customer know and in some instances it was extremely uncomfortable.
So Holder said in a statement, with the new policy effective immediately, the Justice Department is taking an important step to prohibit federal agency adoptions of state and local seizures, except for public safety reasons. His decision allows some limited exceptions, including illegal firearms, ammunition, explosives, and property associated with child pornography, a small fraction of the total. This would eliminate virtually all cash and vehicle seizures made by local and state police
under
from the program.
Federal authority.
Yes.
So if there is a state asset forfeiture authorization, then expect it will continue in your area.
Yes, because this only applies to the federal, and that's what most people use as their justification is, well, federal law allows us to blah, 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 so they just do it.
I wonder if New Hampshire has asset forfeiture laws.
I don't know. I will certainly look into that.
Yeah, because I was going to say, if it does, now would seem to be an optimal time to, you know, wipe those things off the books.
Actually, now, one would think that since the legislature just began their new session, that now would be the perfect time.
It's too late, though.
But because, you know, new legislation has to be filed in
November.
The fall,
then
new legislation can't be introduced, although something certainly could be amended to wind up wiping that out.
So that could happen now, or this November, someone could put something in for the next term.
The article here from the Washington Post continues. It says, while police can continue to make seizures under their own state laws, The federal program was easy to use and required most of the proceeds from the seizure to go to local and state police departments.
I wonder what
many states require seized proceeds to go into the general fund.
Mm-hmm. I was going to say, I wonder what Holder's reasoning was. Does he say anything as to what was the motivation to make this change? I mean, because this was big bucks for the government guys. Like, why would he take this little plaything away?
I'm glad you asked. A justice official who spoke on the condition of anonymity in order to discuss the attorney general's motivation said Holder also believes that the new policy will eliminate any possibility that the adoption process might unintentionally incentivize unnecessary stops and seizures. Holder's decision follows a Washington Post investigation published in September that found that police have made cash seizures worth almost $2.5 billion from motorists and others without search warrants or indictments since September 11th, 2001. And there's a little bit more on this article.
Yeah, it seems like he's just doing the right thing in this case.
I mean, good for him.
Yes.
Credit to this guy. 855-450-FREE. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
The warning signs.
First, he made me feel special. He promised he'd look after me, provide for my future. He broke every promise he made.
Millions of Americans afflicted.
I was ready to leave, but he told me he'd change. So I gave him another chance. I was such a fool.
The consequences.
Things only got worse. He started making my decisions for me, about my job, my kids' education, my money. My safety, my future. He took away my choices, but I kept going back to the same politicians.
The diagnosis? Battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today. At nhliberty.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. We also have a website, freetalklive.com. You can go and get interactive there. And also, freedomsphoenix.com. You can go there to uncover the secrets and expose the lies. That's what the readers of freedomsphoenix.com get every day. They are constantly provided the detailed, real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. FreedomsPhoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com. Sign up for their free daily dispatch. That's FreedomsPhoenix.com. As we continue here, we'll go to your calls and thoughts. Al is listening in Bangor, Maine to WNZS. Hello, Al.
Have to realize the chaos created in Venezuela is not only by the socialists, but by the capitalists as well. And the socialists work hand in hand with the capitalists throughout society, throughout history, to destroy society. It's precisely what they're doing, the U.S. socialists and the capitalists working together. And what they will do, they put the emphasis on the material basis of civilization. You look at the difference between the Democrats and the Republicans. The Democrats say distribute the wealth. The Republicans say increase the wealth. But it is wealth which destroys nations, corrupts them.
What the hell are you talking about, wealth destroys nations? What does that even mean?
I'm still trying to figure out what he's talking about, the difference between Republicans and Democrats.
Yeah, what's the there's no difference between those people.
Well, the difference is that the similarity is that they are based in materialism, that the belief that wealth will improve, enhance human life, and that wealth...
Do you even know what wealth is, Al?
Well, perhaps you can instruct me.
No, I'm asking you. Do you know what wealth is? I mean, you're talking a good game, like you seem to know something about it.
But I have a fair concept of it.
What is it? Can you explain?
Well, it'd be material goods. Possession of material goods.
That's not necessarily true.
Material goods can be an indicator of wealth, but yeah, that's not necessarily true.
I mean, you might feel wealthy and say, like, you know, love from friends and family, and that can make someone feel very wealthy, feel very fortunate. It's not all material. It's not all physical.
Yes, but in the case of the Republicans and Democrats, our current political system, their definition of wealth is very clear. It's material prosperity. And that
and
is
so you're saying material prosperity, you think that destroys nations. Now, when you say destroys
absolutely.
Nations, do you mean it destroys the nation state or it destroys a arbitrary geographic landmass, the lifestyle there? What is being destroyed in your mind when you say that?
Once the nation is destroyed, the state is destroyed with it because the nation produces a state. You have in the case of the U.S.,
that's just a bunch
emphasis.
Of gobbledygook, Al. The nation is, they're both just two ideas. A nation and a state are both ideas, and they are not destroyed or affected in any way by the wealth of
the
people that live there.
They exist in reality, and the nation is very different.
If it were true, Al, that wealth destroyed nations, then we would, well, first of all, then that would mean that North Korea would be one of the strongest nations because they're one of the least wealthy. And
no.
That would
hardly.
Also
hardly. That's prosperity. It's called the course of empire, and you have historians such as Spengler and Toynbee talk about the fall of a civilization. Spengler is very clear that wealth is essentially destructive. For example, you have George Soros.
Tell that to people who don't have air conditioning.
George Soros is the biggest capitalist in the world, you see. But what we found out...
No, I don't believe a word you say, but you can keep saying them. Go ahead.
Just a moment. Are you doubting that he's a capitalist?
I doubt everything that you say, Al, because, you know, you're all kind of jumbled up here. Look, wealth is a nice thing to have. Wealth is the reason why you have a phone that you can talk to us on. Wealth is the reason why you have heat and air conditioning in your home. Those things are wealth. Like, you know, when you have these things that other people in the world don't, the poor person in the United States has more wealth than a rich person did in the United States 150 years prior to that. The poor person in the United States has all kinds of comfortable things that poor people in the rest of the world don't have. So it's much better to be a poor person in the United States than elsewhere because this is a wealthier place. You're more likely to live longer in a wealthier place. You're more likely to live comfortably in a wealthier place. So I think what you're getting at, Al, but you're doing a very poor job of saying it, is that you believe that things and the accoutrements of life, the products that are out there, that the consumer lifestyle is somehow debasing people. Is that what you're saying?
Oh, absolutely. Prosperity in America has been a destructive force, and the forefathers predicted that. To go back to George Soros, who was
George Soros wasn't a founding father.
Look, am I speaking to kindergartners here? Just let me complete a thought. George Soros, everyone knows, is an arch capitalist. He's a billionaire. He also funds the Ferguson protests. From Maine to California, all across the country, numerous left-wing causes. My point is this. The capitalists will support left-wing causes that eventually destroy a nation. They are the force behind massive immigration into the U.S.
You're laughing. So paranoid.
Let me tell you, I think he finished a thought,
but it was not in any way coherent.
No, because you're on their side, pal.
Whose side?
You know.
Whose side?
On the side of Soros. And,
now
Adelson.
There's a new conspiracy. I love this.
Oh, yes, indeed.
So, it's
you're
so funny, Al.
Like they are.
Wait, are we getting money from the Koch brothers or the Soros guy? It's one or the other, right?
No. It could be the same.
Could we
like
get
the
money
Machiavellian thing?
They believe in the same thing you do, the proliferation of drugs, pornography, homosexuality.
Who
exist to destroy our nation. Leftist.
Wait a minute. So wait, are you saying that we're getting money from George Soros or the Koch brothers? Or can we get them? Do you know who the Koch brothers are?
Ideologically, you're the same as a leftist.
Al, I'm
trying
to ask you a question so we can have a conversation. Do you know who the Koch brothers are? I'm just curious.
Oh, certainly. They're capitalists. Support left-wing causes.
So they're left-wingers now, the Koch brothers.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
Are you joking?
Are there any capitalists who support right-wing causes in your mind?
Very, very, very few.
Now, do those people contribute to the downfall of the nation as well?
Well, the Rockefellers are globalists, internationalists. That's well known. The Kennedys. And you go on and on.
Who do you support, George or Al? Who is it that... who would you like to see in charge besides yourself?
I would support a true conservative.
Ah.
A conservative means the ideals and the traditions of the nation.
No, it doesn't.
And... the leftist
conservatism means just the whatever's in the past, they want to keep that. That's what conservatism is, right? You're conserving.
Yes, conserving the traditions of a nation, because once you destroy the ideals of a nation, like the Republicans, the Democrats, the Libertarians want to do with homosexuality, drugs.
So now the Republicans are behind homosexuality and drugs. All right, you know, they're getting
absolutely
better. I got to give them credit for that if that's the case.
I did not know that.
Which party are you going to be voting for? The Prohibitionist Party?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, matter of fact.
That's about all we got there.
Very good.
Oh, that's right.
You
mentioned that previously on the show, didn't you?
You got one thing right.
Gene Amundsen, good old Prohibitionist Party character. He's dead now. Good luck with that, Al. I think there was like 6 people at the Prohibitionist Party convention last year. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Mom, I can't do my math homework. I just don't get it. I hate math. I've always tried to be a good mother, but when it came to Jamie's math, I was at a loss. Then a friend told me about Math Made Easy DVDs. Concepts are simplified in an easy way to follow and review, and students can learn at their own pace in the convenience of home. Listen, in the frustration, call Math Made Easy. Call now, 1-800-USA-MATH. That's 1-800-872-6284. Or visit us at mathmadeeasy.com.
Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people, like when the jeweler ruined my ring and wouldn't do anything about it. But when my Legal Shield attorney called him and told him what my rights were, I received a check for over $2,100. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com, or call 855-340-SAVE. Again, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phones, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live. Of course, you can bring up anything you'd like. Toll free here at 855-450-FREE. You can talk to us liberals. Wait a minute. No, we're not liberals. We're liberty-minded folks
no,
here.
No, yeah, we're not liberals. You could we're conservatives, maybe.
No, definitely not that either. You could describe us as libertarians, although not all libertarians appreciate that particular word. I'm not a fan of it myself, but I'll begrudgingly accept it. It's certainly closer to accurate for me than liberal or conservative.
You could also call us classical liberals.
Yes, true. Classical liberals.
As in, you know, like the old school thought of Jefferson or Bastiat.
What about paleo conservative, Daryl?
Oh, no, I still eat rice.
I I was just going to say, that sounds more like a food option, Ian.
I've heard that one. I don't really know what the source of it is, though.
I've heard the term. I'm not sure exactly what it means.
Yeah, me neither.
But it does, from what I know of it, it sounds very much like classic liberal, libertarian, in meaning. But because the term conservative and liberal shift meanings all the time, and, you know, the actual dictionary definition of the word conservative is one who does not like change.
Correct.
Or claims to want to hold to tradition, then, you know, what is, you know, the tradition of now? You know, people, we need to go back to Leaving the Beaver with the white picket fence and Andy Griffin. Mm. You know, that's,
and
you know,
slavery.
That's right now's, you know, quote unquote traditional values is 60 years ago. And in 60 years, you know, what is going to be considered I wish we could go back to the good old days where we only had to take our shoes off at the airport.
So we just had Al call in a moment ago from Bangor, Maine, and he's just a fascinating caller. You know, he's someone who calls fairly often, so I'm sure we'll hear from him again and get to pick his brain a little bit further, but can only handle so much of that. And, you know, the idea that wealth is somehow destructive, is somehow a destructive force, is just the most ridiculous claim, because wealth is a creative force. When you have wealth, then you can create more wealth on top of that wealth, because basically wealth is created in a lot of ways by human beings taking their brain power, their ideas, and combining their ideas with natural resources to create things that never existed before. So you take trees and rocks and water and, you know, you make them into things. And then, you know, once you have those new things, you have new wealth. You have new products and services and ideas that hadn't existed before, which you can then combine with new ideas and other natural resources and existing products to create newer wealth on top of that, and generation upon generation.
Right. Now,
people get wealthier and life gets easier.
If Al wanted to talk about consumerism causing the downfall of a society, then that would be something a little bit different than wealth.
He'd have a stronger argument in that
case.
Yes,
and I think what he was trying to say, and is, you know, the non-coherent state that it was, it did sound as though he was talking more against consumerism.
Yes.
But he was equating consumerism to wealth. And it seemed as though he was saying that prosperity was something different than wealth.
I think that in the case of consumerism, there's some legitimate concerns, right? The idea being that if there's so much wealth, then people, you know, can just buy all this stuff, and they'll get in the habit of buying to the point where they can't really afford it. So with consumerism comes usually a massive debt load per individual.
Yeah. Right.
And then, of course, once you're getting into debt, you're owned by the credit card companies or whoever it is that's providing those loans to you, the mortgage, etc. And people get to the point where they can't dig out of that hole, that debt hole that they've put themselves in. I think that's certainly a problem.
Right. And if you've ever read the book Brave New World,
I have, actually.
There's one of the things that is taught in, you know, that dream osmosis sort of thing where they repeat the sayings. I forget the exact saying, but it, you know, was something that wound up rhyming of, don't, you know, save or make better whatever you have, just buy something new.
Yeah, a totally consumerist kind of practice there.
Yes.
Absolutely. And you know, people get confused with wealth as just being all about money. But I mean, you know, there's so many different kinds of ways that people can view wealth or prosperity, even, that is not, like, is it not physical?
Something less tangible, like you were talking about having friends and being, like, able to spend time with them.
Yeah, I mean, you know, who here hasn't been in some sort of, like, toxic friendship or relationship? I mean, if you have, like, you know, good, solid people that you feel comfortable with, I mean, that, I mean, you know, you feel very happy, very prosperous with, you know, a good set of people. I mean, that's just one example of something that's not monetary.
Certainly.
Psychic wealth, if you will.
Psychic wealth. Just emotional well-being, I suppose.
So you can share your thoughts with us here. Is wealth a damaging thing? Absolutely not, in my opinion. In fact, it is wealth that is why we're so we are so comfortable today. As we were talking about earlier with the Venezuelan situation, these guys are having a tough time finding toilet paper, detergent, chicken, dish soap, some of the most basic items. There's another article that we didn't have, you know, I didn't want to get into just because we'd covered it pretty deeply. But another news story about the worsening situation in Venezuela said that you have to wait in 20 different lines usually to get 20 different items because the stores are so sold out and so it's so hard to find items on the shelves. You're going constantly from store to store to store just to get your shopping list taken care of. I mean, it's hard to even imagine the difficulty there.
Yeah, that article is saying they had to take days off work to do
that. Yeah, like to go shopping.
Losing money, possibly, to do that.
Yeah, right. And then you combine that with the economic, you know, difficulties and, you know, how do you earn the money to buy the things that you need to buy if you can't actually spend time working because you're spending time standing in lines. I mean, it's just an insane cycle of you want to talk about destructiveness.
Well, you're probably a government employee because everything's nationalized in Venezuela.
Not quite everything, but it would be interesting to see what portion of the industry the government has taken control over there. So, share your thoughts here. Hart is with us in Charleston. You're on Free Talk Live. Hart in West Virginia.
Hey.
Hey there.
Yeah, I was going to ask y'all about what does the International Arms Treaty entail for the United States citizens?
I don't know what you're talking about. What is it?
The International Arms Treaty, it was signed last year. I think 32 countries signed it that are in the UN. Our country signed it. But I didn't know if y'all knew anything more than I did about what it entailed. I know that it's has a lot to do with like amount of ammunition you can have. No more like we couldn't buy Austrian made Glocks or HK products unless they are made in the United States. No more, I didn't know if y'all knew anything about it.
You know, I don't have anything. I feel like it's something that someone might have called in about back when it happened. But unfortunately, you know, we're just talk show hosts. We don't really know much of anything.
Do you know if the Senate ever actually ratified this? Because a president could sign any treaty all day long that he wants, but unless it's been ratified by the Senate, then it is not in force.
Well, see, that's actually what I was calling to see if y'all knew about.
Ah.
I know that it is actually supposed to go into effect on Christmas of 2014, or actually Christmas Eve of 2014, and I didn't know if they're still going to have a, I guess, ratification of it by the Senate or what they're going to do.
Based on information that I'm seeing on Wikipedia, the United States has not ratified this.
Okay.
There's only a handful of countries that have.
So at this point, it's been signed but not ratified, so therefore it's nothing more than a suggestion or something like
that's
that?
That's correct.
Is that what you would say? Yeah, because I felt like if I would have if something had happened to seriously restrict weapons, we probably would have heard some word on the street. I mean, we're in New Hampshire where everybody has, you know, guns, or almost everybody seems to, and we're certainly around a lot of activists who are really, you know, right to bear arms types, and I'm sure there would have been plenty of grousing about this, but I haven't heard word one about it until your call tonight.
I hadn't heard anything either.
So I would say don't worry about it, Hart. It sounds like everything's okay.
All right, I just thought I'd call and ask if y'all know, thought y'all might know more.
There you go. Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. The Mt. Gox owner, Mark Karpeles, says he's not Dread Pirate Roberts. And he has been accused of being Dread Pirate Roberts in court in the Ross Ulbricht trial. That was the big news from the trial yesterday during cross-examination of the federal agent, one of the agents who was investigating the underground marketplace known as the Silk Road. More coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
For 20 years, you've trusted Lumber Liquidators for the best deals on the best selection of floors. Well, this week, get even more deals in our January flooring sale. One beautiful hardwood? Get pre-finished solid hardwood from $189. How about gorgeous bamboo that's twice as hard as oak? We've got strand bamboo for $219. Looking for top quality laminate? This week, get almost half off our thickest and best laminate. Plus other great flooring deals and 18-month special financing. Don't wait. The January flooring sale's going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Alex Jones here. For the last 2 years, I've been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to design a nutraceutical formulation that has truly life-changing health benefits. So many other formulations out there contain toxic ingredients, synthetic additives, and even GMOs. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure ancient defense for you and your family. Visit InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
When commercials come on, don't push the button. Instead, listen. Even if you don't sell things for a living, you're still selling in the various conversations and transactions that make up your busy day. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. So take a lesson from Madison Avenue. Often the fewer words, the more effective the message. Like Jiffy Lube, where you never need an appointment, or the Office Max ad that says, "You supply the ambition, we supply everything else." How about online ticket broker StubHub.com, the way in when it's sold out, or CyberCupid Match.com's seductive, "Go ahead, it's okay to look." How cleverly and succinctly can you distill your message? For more tips, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You dial in here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, you can become an amplifier. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promotes. And you just go to amp.freetalklive.com. That's AMP, amp.freetalklive.com. Get signed up with any major credit card through PayPal or use Visa or MasterCard right through our website. Again, that's amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast, the excellent AMP-only Facebook group, one of the only good reasons to use Facebook, the AMP-only Facebook group, amp.freetalklive.com, among other things. But the real reason to do it is to help us out, because that $5 a month goes to getting on more radio stations and spreading the message of freedom as far and as wide as we possibly can do. So once again, that's amp.freetalklive.com. So an update here from the Silk Road case, a.k.a. the Ross Ulbricht trial that kicked off on Tuesday. It will resume, from what I understand, on Monday. Today was a day off.
Are you sure Monday? Because Monday's a holiday.
Is it? Okay, then I'd heard both Monday and Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
So, you might be right about that.
Probably would be Tuesday, then.
Is it Martin Luther King Day or something?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so probably Tuesday, then. Apologies about that. And here's the latest, because the big bombshell yesterday, as was discussed on Free Talk Live, John Bush called in from thelibertybeat.com. He's done an awesome job of covering what's gone on inside and outside of the trial.
And he did a wonderful interview with Lynn Ulbricht.
The mom of
Ross. Mom, and that
Right now, I believe it's only available on a website called watchmybit.com. Which is, it's a website where you have to pay a couple of Bitcoin to watch.
A couple bits, actually. Or,
yeah, a couple of, like, a couple of
Bitcoin,
pennies.
That's expensive.
A couple of pennies worth of Bitcoin.
Yeah, it's micropayments.
Right, it's micropayments. And in some ways, it's better than having to, you know, watch the little ad at the beginning of the YouTube video because, you know, they're not tracking your demographics.
Yeah, Doug's
so
doing
I,
an interesting
I watched
thing
the
there.
Video this afternoon.
What did you have to pay?
10 cents.
10 cents worth of Bitcoin?
Yes.
Okay. And was it worth it?
Oh, definitely.
Okay, cool. I'm glad to hear that because I feel like when we had Doug on the show, who's the guy who's behind watchmybit.com, when we were down at the Coins in the Kingdom event down in Orlando, and I like the idea, but I'm so used to getting videos for free online.
Right.
It just, I feel like, are people really going to use this? So I'm glad to hear that you've actually dug into your pocket and spent some Bitcoin to watch a video online.
Yes. I'm
just wondering.
Yeah, so they're currently still in beta. So, yeah. You know, there are some bugs to work out with the site. But I definitely think that it's going to wind up being something big.
Hmm. All right, cool. Well, we'll definitely keep our eyes on that.
It's an interesting concept. I mean, 10 cents a video.
Well, it's not necessarily 10 cents a video. The person that uploads the video gets to set the rate.
Oh, okay.
So it could be 2 cents or whatever.
Right. It could, in theory, be 1/10 of one penny to you know encourage more people to watch your video.
If it's 1/10 of one penny?
Bitcoin only.
Oh, okay.
So that's at watchmybit.com?
Yes.
Okay. So we were talking about the big news from yesterday, and that is that the allegation that it was Mark Karpeles, the founder of MT Gox, who is, in point of fact, Dread Pirate Roberts. At least that's according to the defense attorney in this case. He was interviewing or cross-examining the agent, Mr. Duryegahan, or however you pronounce that guy's name. And
I've been saying it Duryegahan.
Duryegahan. And so in that cross-examination, he got Duryegahan to admit that he had, in point of fact, been investigating Mark Karpeles as possibly being Dread Pirate Roberts. We've yet to hear why he changed from investigating Karpeles into Ulbricht, and I imagine we'll hear that on the cross or the recross or whatever you want to call it when it's cross-examination. Then what do you call it then, like recross or cross-cross? Or?
I have no idea.
Where the prosecutor gets to go again with his witness.
Right. It's essentially a rebuttal, but rebuttal, they have a different legal term for it.
Anyway, so I imagine we're going to hear more about that.
Redirect.
Thank you for that, yeah. So here's Karpeles' statement, or some sort of news report about his statement, because he has now spoken out claiming to not be Dread Pirate Roberts. And further, he says he is not involved with the Silk Road and does not condone what has been happening. Today, this according to Nathan Mattis in over at arstechnica.com. Today, in the ongoing Silk Road trial, defense attorney Joshua Dreidel and his client, defendant Ross Ulbricht, made another bold proclamation. A day after the defense stated Ulbricht was not Dread Pirate Roberts, they pursued a line of questioning suggesting who actually controlled the online drug marketplace. Mark Karpeles, the owner of the MT Gox Bitcoin exchange. Karpeles told ours via email, quote, this is probably going to be disappointing for you, but I am not Dread Pirate Roberts. The investigation reached that conclusion already. This is why I'm not the one sitting during the Silk Road trial, and I can only feel that defense attorney Joshua Dreidel is trying everything he can to point the attention away from his client, unquote. Ours reached out to Karpeles soon after his name came up in court today, with the Department of Homeland Security representative mentioning that he was at one point a suspect for being Dread Pirate Roberts. We asked if he ever had any connection to Silk Road. Karpeles continued, quote, I have nothing to do with Silk Road and do not condone what has been happening there. I believe Bitcoin and its underlying technology is not meant to help people evade the law, but to improve everyone's way of life by offering never thought before possibilities. As for the SilkRoadMarket.org domain, it was registered by a KayleeHost.com customer and paid in bitcoins. Apparently, he's claiming that wasn't him because the allegation was in court that he was the owner of SilkRoadMarket.org. When asked about more specific suggestions made in court that Karpeles' lawyers offered to tell the government who ran Silk Road and perhaps led them to Ulbricht, Karpeles says he didn't know how much he could say, but denied knowing the man who's now on trial. He wrote, quote, I did not know Ross Ulbricht until his name was published after he was arrested. It was not uncommon for MT Gox to cooperate with law enforcement within the scope of Japanese law. In court earlier, Dreidel asked Homeland Security agent Jared Duryegahan about his earlier suspicions that Karpeles was running Silk Road. Duryegahan acknowledged being suspicious at an earlier time, saying he filled out an affidavit in mid-2013, saying that by the contents of that affidavit, yes, Duryegahan answered from the stage. Both the government and U.S. District Judge Catherine Forrest were surprised by the approach. Prosecutor Saren Turner initially objected, saying Dreidel was trying to get hearsay evidence. When the jury was sent out of the room, Dreidel stated his thesis more clearly, saying, quote, they had this guy, Karpeles, in their sights, and he'd never been charged. Our position is that he set up Mr. Ulbricht.
Now, something that's interesting, and I learned from watching the interview with Lynn Ulbricht that John Bush did, the affidavit was initially introduced as evidence by the prosecution, but yet the prosecution wanted to object to it as hearsay when the defense brought it up.
The affidavit that the agent thought it was Karpeles? That affidavit?
Like all of the affidavits signed by the DHS agent were introduced as evidence. Like, you know, here's all of the evidence that he had that, you know, shows that Ross Ulbricht. And so the defense attorney pulls out this one affidavit that mentions investigating Mark Karpeles and questions.
Objection!
Hearsay! But you introduced
this! It's the guy on the stand. He can testify to what he said.
Right.
Hearsay is when someone else, or when you say someone else said something. That's hearsay.
Right.
And so the judge did, of course, overrule that objection, and rightly so.
And I had a situation in Keene. The last time I was in court for a trial where the prosecution introduced something as evidence, I asked the police officer about it, and the prosecution objected that it was hearsay. The officer's notes from a ticket that I received were hearsay.
Was it overruled?
No!
Oh, Burke sustained that one?
Burke sustained it!
So we will find out more about this case as time goes on, expecting it to come back into the courtroom in Manhattan on Tuesday morning. That's the latest. That's all we know now. And in the meantime, Ross Ulbricht continues to be in a jail cell while he awaits the verdict, whatever that will be, which could be 4, 5, 6 weeks from now. And who knows? That's could be the length of the case. And who knows how long it's going to take for the jury to actually reach a verdict. Let's go to James in Arizona. You're on Free Talk Live. Go, James.
Yeah, bang your head, Al was on to something. You guys are just hard right-wing progressives. You believe in dope and change. You want to fundamentally transform the United States of America. You believe that not having to wear clothes is because it's a societal norm that you don't have any respect. You believe in having consensual sex with kids is okay as long as they're okay with it. There's many things I could go on and on about. Most importantly, though,
too bad you don't have time. See you later, James.
Yes, because we have always talked about not wearing clothes around. What?
Yeah, yeah. He was totally misrepresenting almost every position that we have.
I'm sorry, if I go
and I don't even understand what right wing progressive means.
I don't either, but I did enjoy his shot at Alan Bangor. That was kind of
funny. He's a banger head. Bam, yeah. Bam, bam.
It's kind of cute. All right. See you tomorrow. Online in the meantime, freetalklive.com. Check out darylfpp.cc.
Free Talk Live.
I cannot imagine anyone ever calling a cigarette interdiction hotline.
That'd be great.
What would that conversation be like?
Well, I'm calling because I can't stop smoking.
Sir, do you have a cigarette right now?
Well, yes.
Is it lit?
Uh-huh.
Okay, you have an ashtray?
Yes.
Okay, you know when you're done with your cigarette and you put it out?
Uh-huh.
Okay, try that right now.
But it's not.
Go ahead and do that same motion.
I can't imagine the conversations.
What the hell could I possibly
say? Is it 24 hours?
I just don't get it.
Someone call him. I can't do that anymore.
It's dumb.
I smoked the whole pack of cigarettes.
I only get motivated at 3 a.m. Help me out. There's nobody there.
I've smoked all my money away, and now my wife's left me, and she took the dog and the kids. I got no money left. I've smoked it all.
I was breaking into my neighbors' houses and pawning their TVs cigarettes.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The Corey Moore Show is coming up next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, January 16th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.15 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,268 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $210. Antiwar.com reports a pair of U.S. drone strikes have killed 13 people in Pakistan's tribal areas, with 7 killed in a dawn attack on a North Waziristan house and 6 more killed in a second strike in South Waziristan. None of the slain in either attack was identified by name, though Pakistani officials predictably labeled everyone a suspected terrorist. 2 were said to be ethnic Uzbeks. Conspicuously, the Pakistani government has offered no criticism of the recent flurry of U.S. drone strikes after the strikes had ground to a halt in the wake of Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif's election and loud criticism of the campaign. In recent months, the U.S. has escalated the attacks back to pre-election levels, and Pakistani officials aren't even offering the token complaints they were before. This suggests that, despite the massive unpopularity of the attacks among Pakistani voters, yet another Pakistani government has a secret understanding about the U.S. campaign. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports the United States announced sweeping new rules on Thursday that will significantly ease sanctions on Cuba, opening up the communist-ruled island to expanded U.S. travel, trade, and financial activities. Defying hardline critics in Congress, President Obama made good on his commitment last month to loosen restrictions on dealing with Cuba as part of a historic effort to end decades of hostility. The U.S. embargo on Cuba, in place for 54 years, will remain. Only Congress can lift it. But the package of regulations issued by the Treasury and Commerce Departments, which will take effect on Friday, will allow U.S. exports of telecommunications, agricultural, and construction equipment, permit more travel by Americans to the island, and open banking relations. Airlines in the United States will be permitted to expand flights to the Caribbean island beyond the existing chartered flights that